Welcome to ESPN College Football, presented by McDonald's. We're in the Bull City on the campus of North Carolina Central University, the 4-1 NCCU Eagles hosting the Morgan State Bears from O'Kelly Riddick Stadium. And as we take a look at the top five teams in Jay's HBCU Power Rankings, North Carolina Central coming in at number two, they've gotten off to a great start. Slipped up last week. However, the Eagles are soaring high right now. As we say hello and welcome you in with the former Howard University and NFL quarterback, Jay Walker, I'm Tiffany Green. And right now, if you are an NCCU Eagle fan, you have to love the start that they've had to this season of the third-year head coach, Trey Oliver.
Yeah, an alumnus of the school. And, you know, you have to have a recipe and a formula, and everybody has to buy in. And the first 2 years of Trey Oliver as a head coach, they didn't get the results they wanted. But here in year three, as you say, the Eagles are soaring high to some of the highest levels we haven't seen for them in quite some time.
And one of the things that you have to point out is the star quarterback, who is the signal caller for the Eagles, Davius Richard, in now his junior season, and he's running the show.
Yeah, what do we always say? Give me the team that has the best quarterback on the field, and you're probably going to win the football game. In the case of Davius Richard, a very special talent out of Belgrade, Florida, he has the ability to pick apart a defense with his brain, physically able to move and be a mobile, dual threat quarterback. But at the end of the day, Davius Richard's number one asset is he knows how to hurt defenses when the game's on the line, making clutch throws like that. I have him as an early contender for the Midwest Athletic Conference Player of the Year.
Well, he's certainly been playing like it thus far, Jay. Meanwhile, when you look on the other side for Morgan State, their running back, Alfonso Grant, he has been the dude for Damon Wilson.
When you look at the history of Morgan State football, whenever they've had success, it's been when they've had a great rushing attack. The school from Baltimore is tough and gritty, and he's a Baltimore kid, and he has that same tenacity on the football field. Graham is special. What I really like, he never has to leave the game. He can hurt you from the backfield. He can hurt you in between the tackles. He picks up his blocking schemes. He's a guy that's got NFL talent. We're going to need him to show up big today if Morgan State wants to try and pull off an upset here in Durham.
The MEAC's leading rusher, coming off a career best 203 yards in his last game. Meanwhile, we talked about Damon Wilson, the first-year head coach for Morgan State, came over from the D2 ranks where he had unbelievable success with Bowie State after 13 seasons. Now he steps up to the MEAC.
Long overdue for Damon Wilson to get his chance. And for the first time, I think America's going to see him on a national stage. Ultra-competitive, the Division II National Coach of the Year a season ago. I think it was a great hire by Morgan State, hiring Damon Wilson. And we'll see if he can have that same success he had on the Division II level at the FCS level.
Made the hire earlier this year to try to turn the Bears football program around. And before the game, we saw Damon Wilson chatting it up with Trey Oliver, who we mentioned, alumnus of NCCU, when he played back here in the late 90s. And so now these two coaches will go head-to-head as their teams are set to do battle just after we come back from the break. It's going to be a good one, rumbling, tumbling, mumbling from Durham.
Hella curved animation like the Matrix. This day's dark outside.
Let's go!
Even when it's daytime.
Let's get it!
Bye-bye.
An ABC doubleheader.
Undefeated Clemson, the crucial Atlantic Coast Conference collision.
You have no idea what's going to happen on any given Saturday.
Oklahoma State, TCU. Clemson, Florida State. Saturday on ABC.
Back here at NCCU. A MEAC showdown on this Thursday night between Morgan State and North Carolina Central. Morgan State won the toss. They defer, so we'll get a chance to see the Eagles on offense and their quarterback, Davius Richard. Morgan State, 2-3 on the season, trying to bounce back from that heartbreaking loss against Norfolk State there. Come back, halted just short in that 24-21 decision. Meanwhile, North Carolina Central had an off week, and so they take the field for the first time since October 1st. We are set and ready to go here from O'Kelly Riddick Stadium. We're underway on this Thursday night. Central on the return. That's Chris Mosley. Mosley, who has a lot of speed, popping to the outside. And he's tripped up. Well, Chris Mosley, we'll get a chance to see him featured on offense as well, the junior out of Fort Worth, Texas. But also, it's America's first chance to see on this Thursday night. Davius Richard, we mentioned him in the open, knows the offense. This dual threat quarterback out of Belgrade Ford, as you mentioned, Jay, has been playing great football.
Great size, and the one thing that doesn't show up, his strength. Very strong runner, difficult to bring down. You see the guns right there. He can throw with a strong arm, but very well put together specimen.
Latrell, a.k.a. Mookie Collier, joining him in the backfield, and they hand it off and keep it on the ground with Collier. Collier, who came over from Marshall a few seasons ago, picked up two on the carry. Well, Davius Richard, second team All-MEAC selection a season ago, had 294 yards, a couple of touchdowns, and two INTs as well in that loss to Campbell, their lone slip up of the season. Quentin McCall in motion from the 31. And he finds McCall. It was bobbled. Did he have possession going out? They say it's incomplete.
That's when you have to make it. One thing about North Carolina Central is they have a tendency to get off to slow starts. And, you know, you want to get them going early. If your offensive coordinator, Matt Leone, just doesn't catch the ball cleanly the first time, bringing up a third and long on your very first series. Not the start, I'm sure, that Trey Oliver wants to see from his offense.
We'll see what the Eagles dial up here on third down. Richard decides to take off the leading rusher for this group, and he's able to pick up the first down. 286 yards on the ground this season, and he tacks on 12 more.
Yeah, really like the play selection here. They flex out their running back, Collier, go to empty backfield. Only one linebacker middle field. He was stuck. If he went left, Richard was going right, and if he went to the right, they would have gone left. So, great play design.
Richard, who coming off of last season, better than 2,100 yards through the air, but also punched in 8 rushing touchdowns as well. So, again, we mentioned can do it both ways. They keep it on the ground. Here's Collier to the left side, and he's stopped up and brought down by Lawrence Richardson, the weak side linebacker.
And that's what you have to do. You have to pursue. Good effort by Richardson going down the line. And what you're going to see from defensive coordinator Antoine Sewell for Morgan State, fast defenders. He doesn't really care about the size, but he needs guys that can run sideline to sideline, creating havoc.
Richard taking his time as the Eagles' offense has 4 wide receivers on the field. Collier to his left on second down. The pass out, and that's Quentin McCall with the catch, beating the defender across the 35, and then he's wrapped up by a number of Morgan State jerseys. A gain of 23 for Quentin McCall.
Yeah, and I think Josh Graham, the cornerback, learned a lesson. Strong arm quarterbacks can get away with these type of throws. That ball had a lot of velocity. Graham tried to undercut the route. Risk wasn't worth it. Big play for North Carolina Central.
So they move closer into Bears territory. They're in Bears territory now at the 31-yard line. This is a NCCU team who has high hopes and expectations as they start off play in the MEAC. Great throw, zipped it in there, and touchdown. E.J. Hicks on the receiving end. A 31-yard strike from Davius Richard to E.J. Hicks on the opening possession.
They can play. This is just four vertical routes here. Put them in no man's land, run up the seam. Slow to get over from a safety position was Jaden Wooden. They put him on an island, and Richard absolutely threw a strike for the touchdown.
So third receiving touchdown of the season for E.J. Hicks as Adrian Olivio is on to attempt the extra point.
Extra point.
And six plays, 71 yards, and Trey Oliver has to be pleased because you said slow starts, but they're starting off fast here, opening with a score. It's Davius Richard going through the air right into the crawl of E.J. Hicks.
It all started when we showed up in Austin waving a Wazoo flag, trying to get game day to come to Pullman. Then it kind of became an obsession. I'm Tom Pounds, and this is the story of the Cougar that wouldn't quit. We flew Old Crimson at every game day. And after 15 years, game day finally came to Washington State. And I lost my mind. Now we keep doing it because game day isn't just a day, it's a lifestyle.
The game has never been better. That is hockey.
At the core of us all burns a passion for greatness. It's the rhythm of our hearts, the desire to ascend to greater heights, the drive to persevere and push beyond expectations. At North Carolina Central University, we fan that flame in an innovative and inclusive community driven by a relentless pursuit of excellence. It's here at NCCU, in the heart of Research Triangle, that you will soar with the Eagles and discover what's central to you.
Next in Market Watch, numbers. Boring. In more delicious news, Carl's Jr. and Hardee's are offering Charbroil double deals starting at $2.99 each.
Bite into these double deals starting at $2.99 each at Carl's Jr. and Hardee's.
Team, I need a volunteer. We need promotional products.
I'm on it.
4imprint makes promotional product success easy. For high quality items, go to 4imprint.com. 4imprint, for certain.
An early 7-0 advantage for the home team Eagles, and going back to that last touchdown, Jay, you like the way Davius Richard played that quarterback position. Why?
Yeah, this is why. Take a look at number 12 in white, Jaden Wooden. He's the free safety, right? You run vertical routes. Watch the headset of Davius Richard. Watch how he looks him to the left and comes back and throws right. I'm going left. The moment he takes two steps, sticks it back to the right. That's big-time quarterback play from Davius Richard, letting you know he gets it.
This one bounces into the end zone, so a touchback and a chance to introduce you to the Morgan State offense led by transfer quarterback Carson Baker. Baker, a graduate out of San Diego, California. He's kind of been a journeyman, if you will. Started out at San Diego State, then Western Kentucky, and brought in over the summer and found a home in Baltimore.
Second consecutive year, Morgan State has had a quarterback from San Diego.
Yeah.
So whether it's San Diego State or University of San Diego, but they must find something there. But Carson Baker trying to make the most of his chances. As you mentioned, well-traveled in his collegiate career.
They hand it off to Alfonso Graham. Graham, who we featured in the open and who was wrapped up and spun down very quickly. A loss of 4. Thomas Johnson credited for the TFL. Well, you see the journey that Baker took, had the opportunity to play at San Diego State, but then they switched the style of offense when they brought in a new coaching staff. And when he transferred to Western Kentucky, didn't get the starting job there, but now has full reins of this offense at Morgan State. On second and 14, flush out of the pocket, tips it over to Graham, and Graham just bobbled it, couldn't catch it, brings up third and long.
Ooh, got to make those plays right there. Good job by Carson Baker stepping up in the pocket. Graham, you have to make this one. You just need some type of positive yardage to try and make it an reachable or attainable third down, but this is third and long against this North Carolina Central defense. Pretty sure they'll probably play some soft zone coverage, keep everything in front, and see if the defensive lineman, particularly Kobe Warrior, can get penetration.
That's number 27 in black to the bottom of your screen. Here's Baker looking in and completes the pass to Andre Crowley. Crowley, who stopped up short a few yards of the first down. It's Shekhi Brevard making the tackle.
And that's college football. So think about the previous play. If Graham can hold on and pick up 3 or 4 yards, then this is a first down throw on the curl route there. But the receiver had to pick up some yardage after the catch. Not able to do so. Got to execute when you're coming on the road trying to pull an upset against one of your conference rivals.
So a 3 and out for Oregon State as Jordan Amundi, on to punt it away. E.J. Hicks, who caught that touchdown pass, now in the return game. A little shifty and brought down near the 35-yard line after that 37-yard punt. Well, that opening drive, it was North Carolina Central who saw a few plays, in fact, 3 in total, go for 10 yards or more, and Davius Richard with that great throw in the end zone to E.J. Hicks for his 10th passing touchdown of the season. Richard, that's exactly what he has the ability to do. And you talked about that 6'3" frame, very strong, very crafty and good with his legs, a gain of 12.
Yeah, when we say strong, we mean the boy's strong.
Yeah.
I mean, we're talking about a quarterback that can bench press 225 pounds 25 times. That's linebacker-type strength, has the ability to pull it. But more importantly, as a quarterback, number one job is to do what, Tim?
Throw the football.
Throw the football, and he can throw it with the best of them.
Well, that was one of the things they talked about. Hey, let's make sure you maintain that flexibility on the outside. There's Latrell Collier, and Collier with a strong run and hyped up on the sideline afterward from his teammate, Jordan Tolles, on that stop for 13.
Yeah, and they caught him. They had a run blitz going to the left side. They run the ball the opposite side. So you see, there was basically nobody out there. With the collision hard hitting, North Carolina Central is trying to establish, even from their running backs, that they want to push around this Morgan State team.
And in talking with Trey Oliver, he felt very confident about the bunch he had coming back after finishing second in the MEAC a season ago. Richard stumbled, and taking advantage of it was Elijah Williams to bring him down, a loss of 6.
Well, good job by Williams, not giving up. He's what they call their best defensive lineman in terms of consistency, can defend against the run in the pass, just doesn't give up. Richard holds on to the ball, maybe just a little bit too long, relying on his athleticism. Good job by the Bear defense.
We'll see if Damon Wilson's crew can capitalize off of that sack and build some momentum. That's what they want to do, is trying to create havoc and turnovers. They'll also take loss of yardage for the opposing team. Flicks it out and finds Mookie Collier. Collier, who's just so speedy and gained most of those yardage, most of that yardage back and more. It's near a first down. They say it's good enough for it after 17.
Yeah, little slip screen. You know, where's Collier going? You know he's a marked man. Well, it appears like he's going to block. Instead, they just give it to him on a quick turnaround. And they really set that up nicely because they didn't ask the lineman. The lineman did not show that it was a screen pass. That was basically a one-on-one, get the ball to Mookie in space and watch him run.
Collier, who will take a breather in the backfield now, is Jamari Taylor. Taylor, the sophomore out of Charlotte, who is also versatile. Very similar to Collier in a number of ways, according to the coaching staff. Up ahead in a game of 3. And after the play, the flag comes out as there appeared to be some extra activity after the run. A MEAC officiating crew with Jason Soisman as the referee tonight.
One, two, three.
goes against the middle linebacker, Eric Hunter. Hunter out of Capitol Heights, Maryland, aiding this drive for Central after that 15-yard penalty. So now that sets him up inside the red zone with first and 10 from the 18. From the 13, excuse me, as they run up ahead, and that's again Jamari Taylor on the carry.
And one thing you see about North Carolina Central, they say they don't have a lot of star power, but they're very difficult to game plan. On every play, rarely do they line up and just snap the ball. They're going to do some type of shift, some type of motion, something to make the defense readjust on every single play. They'll come out here in the red zone, basic formation look, what are you going to get? Now they're going to shift somebody, move them from left to right to make you declare your weakness, identify who you can attack.
Richard keeping it all the way. And Elijah Williams was there to bring him down. Now bring up third down to the yard line to gain. Is the four for Morgan State, of Morgan State, rather.
Big play coming up right now. I mean, you're on the road early. You don't want to go down by two scores. If you can limit them by two touchdowns, I say, you can limit them to a field goal attempt. At this point, you give your offense an opportunity to crank it up and get you into the game. Let's see what the Bears can dial up on defense.
Forcing the first third down of this drive.
There goes that shift with the motion and the reset.
Richard looking into the end zone, and it's caught. Devin Smith with the touchdown reception. The local product out of Durham Riverside helps NCCU go up by two scores.
The coaches called Smith their best player. He was actually open for a little while. Right now he's open. He's waiting for the football. And fortunate to get that ball there just in time. But it was that shift causing the distraction between the linebackers and the safety on who's responsible for who that allowed Devin Smith to get to the end zone untouched.
Again, a number of plays of 10 yards or more helping NCCU put up two touchdowns on the Bears. This time, on the receiving end, it's Devin Smith with the score.
The new iPhone 14 Pro. It's amazing.
Yep, the camera's incredible. And you'll get our best deal.
Nice, but everyone should get it.
Everyone can get it.
Every new customer.
And every existing customer.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Okay, my work here is done. Everyone gets the best deal on every iPhone.
Best one yet.
Everyone gets AT&T's best deals on every iPhone, including up to $800 off iPhone 14 Pro.
Are you coming for my job? Welcome to Independence.
You know, people here, they're all running from something.
Is something rattling you?
My husband was killed.
Who killed him?
The new sheriff. You asked me if I was staying here for revenge. Maybe it's justice.
Walker, Independence. New series. Check your local listings for showtimes only on the CW and the CW app.
With my hectic life, you'd think retirement would be the last thing on my mind.
Hey, Mom, can I go play video games?
Sure.
After homework.
Thankfully, Voya provides comprehensive solutions and shows me how to get the most out of my workplace benefits.
What's the Wi-Fi password again?
Here you go.
Cool. Thanks.
No problem. Voya helps me feel like I got it all under control. Because I do.
Oh, she is good. Voya. Well planned, well invested, well protected.
It's a beautiful time for basketball. A season fresh with hope and stars vying for greatness. Heated rivalries with MVP talent. NBA Opening Week begins Wednesday and continues Friday on ESPN.
ESPN
ESPN College Football is presented by McDonald's Black and Positively Golden Movement, elevating the next generation of Black excellence.
Good look at Black Wall Street, which was the hub of African-American Black-owned businesses in Durham during the late 1800s, early 1900s, during that Reconstruction area. It's located in downtown Durham on Parrish Street. And when you think about the Hayside District, that was the heart of it all. Among the vibrant and successful Black-owned businesses that were around then, Mechanics and Farmers Bank, the second oldest minority-owned bank in the U.S., and North Carolina Mutual Life Insurance Company, which is the largest Black-owned insurance company in the world, still in existence both today.
Scooter, thank you. I learned a little something I'd heard about the Black Wall Street, obviously, in Tulsa, the one here in North Carolina.
Keith Jenkins schooling right now. The special teams on the return, and Keith Jenkins has one man to beat, lunges ahead, across the 30, and a great setup return for the Morgan State Bears to try to capitalize right here.
Well, they needed this. Give the ball to your offense in great field position. This is just going up the crease right there. Turns on the jets. Becomes a foot race as he's running. Looks like he was going to be able to take it all the way to the house, but a great job of pursuit. Chauncey spikes it.
But how about Keith Jenkins, the true freshman out of Gainesville, Georgia, a 72-yard return for the Bears.
Just a freshman. They're going to tease about that. Yeah. You got to finish that. You get a crease like that. He slowed down like knowing that he was getting walked down, but nevertheless, great field position for Morgan State. And they do that, you get a great return, and then you have two guys move at the same time on the ball, so now all of a sudden you got first and 15. We're going to call it down. You get so hyped up, you got a great return. Let's go out here. And then you get a penalty for the first play.
And for Morgan State, they want to be able to answer back here on this drive, set up by the longest return of the season for the Bears. And UT Sherman, the offensive coordinator, we'll see what he dials up here. Carson Baker looking, going to the outside, and miscommunication. Thrown out of bounds. Tyler Wilkins was the nearest receiver in the area.
Yeah, the miscommunication. You know, one thing you hate as an offensive coordinator, if your offensive line gives you protection, go the right place for the football. In that case there, it seemed like you had even a check down that would have gotten you positive yardage. An incomplete pass on first down drive, offensive coordinator is crazy. Still have to get the ball to Graham. In this situation, although you want to throw it, Graham needs to get his touches to get it going.
Instead, they keep it through the air, and the pass is complete to Crawley. Crawley has a clear pass to the end zone, and the score. 33-yard catch and run by Andre Crawley, and the answer right back from the Bears.
What Morgan State team is this? I mean, this is a great job. It all starts with paying attention to Graham. They come up, they fall for the play fake, wide open crease down the middle of the field, but you have to be proud if you're a Morgan State fan. Traditionally, they go down 14 points, and it's going to be a long night. They come right back and answer on special teams and the offense to get themselves in this game.
Well, Crawley catches the touchdown, and then is the holder here for Beckett Leary, and trimming it to just down by a touchdown on the road, but again, set up by a terrific special teams play from Keith Jenkins, and then finishing things off is Andre Crowley, 14-7 from Durham.
An ABC doubleheader.
Undefeated Clemson, the crucial Atlantic Coast Conference collision.
You have no idea what's going to happen on any given Saturday.
Oklahoma State, TCU. Clemson, Florida State. Saturday on ABC.
This is El Clasico.
I'm gonna go. I ain't got time for my energy.
dropping a bomb.
Great play, Benzema,
steady himself. Protecting my energy. Si no te quiero, it's cause you ain't a friend of me. To all who are kin to me, I'm leaving the legacy.
Nope.
On an urgent Fansville by Dr. Pepper.
Hurry! It's almost kickoff.
I am.
Oh, they logged me out! What's the password?
Okay, it's P23XR&
Dude, the cat's lock is on! Ah, how much time we got?
I miss basic cable.
Here we go. What was that? What was that? Oh no, I got the spinning wheel!
Fanstown by Dr. Pepper.
This commercial. Game hasn't started.
They play these too much.
Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve.
And his crew cutting the lead in half. And you know, you talked about in his first season as head coach at Morgan State trying to instill or reinstill the winning tradition, much like he had in terms of success at Bowie State for those 13 seasons. Won 3 CIAA championships back to back to back, and now he's hungry for his squad to be in contention for a MEAC title. Chris Mosley on the return, and Mosley slipping through. And out across the 35. Well, this Saturday, the first of our two featured college football games on ABC. A massive Big 12 matchup as number 8 Oklahoma State takes on 13th ranked TCU at 3:30. Then our Saturday night football game presented by Capital One features number 4 Clemson and the Florida State Seminoles from Dope Campbell Stadium at 7:30 Eastern. And we'll, of course, have some very colorful commentary from Pat McAfee and his crew, who's been highlighting our ESPN2 telecasts. Well, Davius Richards so far in this game, 4 for 5 through the air with 78 yards passing as they hand it off to Chris Mosley. Mosley, who picks up a few, but you talk about the establishing of a quarterback and how you build your team around that. How do you see this team being different from last year when we saw them in the MEAC Sweat Challenge against Alcorn State to now?
I think they're on the same page offensively. They're coordinating with the play selection. The quarterback has become an extension of the offensive coordinator on the field of play and the confidence. I mean, we saw Richard last year would be good, but sometimes he'd be average. Now I think this season he's playing at a high level week in and week out.
The carry and tripped up as that's Mosley again as he wanted a little bit more. Gain of 3, 3rd and short on the way.
You know, then when you think about it too, is also the offensive line. I mean, we're seeing Richard drop back. He's really not getting touched. So they brought back so many experienced players. You know, Corey Bullock is the best of the bunch over at left tackle, number 51. The rest of the guys that are there are good players. They've been in the program. Simpkins, the center, has a lot of talent. So a quarterback, an offensive line, and some skill guys, it's going to be a pretty potent offense.
Well, right tackle Daquan Thomas came off the field with an injury, and that was something that they battled through last year as that O-line was riddled with it. This year, as you mentioned, Jay, it's been a strength for the Eagles. On 3rd and short, dropping back to throw it as Richard, who is hit once, twice, and finally goes down, but a first down is the result of the play.
He's strong.
I mean, say that again, Jay.
He's strong. He is strong. This is what you go to the weight room for. You see him, capable runner, but finishes off runs. Not afraid to avoid, to hit contact, because he knew the yardage that was needed to get the first down. That's leadership from that position. Right now, Davis Richard seems to be in complete control. And he got green eyes to go with it.
And he got, what'd you call him, the green eye bandit?
The green eye bandit. Double move, got him.
On the outside, and the receiver falls down, and you saw it. Jay, as a quarterback, your eyes immediately went to Quentin McCall on the outside.
Oh, he had him there. I mean, they fell for this hook, line, and sinker there. The DB was bending. That's a hold. Oh, wow. Oh, they got away with one. Javion Morton did what he was taught to do. If you fall for the play fake, grab it. We'll take a holding penalty, not a touchdown. But in this case, Morton got away with the hold and the incompletion. You can't miss that call. That's particularly on double move. That's the first thing you're supposed to look for. Tough break for North Carolina Central.
Second and 10. Passing right to the middle of the field. Was popped up and Morton was in the area. And the ball goes right over his head. And Davius Richard, very fortunate, as Kyle Morgan had it go through his fingertips.
And Morgan is more the blocking tight end, but they get him out in pass coverage, step up. This ball has a lot of zip on it, but you got to make that catch. You know, you're a Division I football player, and this ball is thrown accurately. Just got up on a little quicker, slow hands, and as you said, the Eagles are fortunate that ball wasn't picked off.
.355 in the first quarter, third and 10 for North Carolina Central. Scored on their first two drives, and they're trying to keep this one going as E.J. Hicks, who caught one of those touchdowns earlier along the sideline, and some laundry comes flying out at the end of the play.
Holding on the offense on the perimeter. It really wasn't necessary. It really wasn't necessary, but the wide receivers blocking downfield, turn them around. Depending on where they spot the hold, where it was down the field.
That was
so you'll see at the end right there. I mean, that's a bear hug. You know, you got him grabbed there, two hands on the outside. But because it happened down the field, it'll still be a third and short when they replay the down.
Joaquin Davis, the guilty party so far tonight. North Carolina Central has been perfect on third downs. 3 for 3. And Morgan State trying to get lined up, some confusion on defense, and before the snap. North Carolina Central.
Smart timeout.
Spending the timeout.
Smart timeout, but the key is the officials weren't allowing them to snap the ball. And I don't understand why, because they had plenty of time, and Morgan State was trying to bring in like seven guys from the sideline. And I think that's what Trey Oliver's saying. Like, why would you let us snap the ball? Instead, we had to call a timeout. I mean, there was so much time in between. I understand his right. Morgan State was not ready, and the official, for some reason, would not let them snap the ball, thinking it was not enough time to substitute. They missed it.
Well, good time to tell our viewers that our Week 6 Monday Night Football matchup features another AFC West showdown. Russell Wilson and the Broncos taking on the 3-2 Chargers at SoFi Stadium. Game time 8 Eastern on ESPN. And our coverage begins with the Monday Night Countdown at 6. The Chargers, who have won 2 straight on the road, coming home for another 2 at SoFi Stadium. Richard steps up in the pocket and is able to convert another third down. Again, remaining perfect on the night as Xavier Shell brings him down after that pickup of 4.
Starting to see Morgan State get a little bit restless. 4 down linemen, yet they still brought a slot blitzer, so they're trying to get to the pocket and force Richard to leave his comfort zone, but Davis Richard doing a good job of climbing the pocket, picking up first down yardage with his legs.
Coming in with 48 carries, 286 yards on the ground for the Eagles from his quarterback position, hands it off, and Lukey Collier is bottled up after a short game. Marino Dindo with the stop.
Yeah, great individual play by Dindo, but Elijah Williams from his defensive end position, he caused that. You know he's got to play the pass and set the edge, but had the ability to swim the lineman and make that tackle to minimize that play where it looked like there was a running lane inside. That's a matchup to watch. Number 0 versus number 51 in black. Defensive end going against the left tackle.
Again, very deliberate from the Eagles' offense, making sure they get the play that they want. And dropping back, and again, right there is Xavier Shell on the stop. No gain on the play. It's 3rd and 9.
Caught that slip screen again, and you give Morgan State credit. They're bending now. They're sending a lot of bodies. You know, you're seeing a blitzer from the secondary almost on every play, consecutive plays. But good assignment football forces 3rd and long.
More importantly, can this Morgan State defense get a stop on 3rd down?
This is the time they've been sending blitzers. North Carolina Central's made the adjustment. I call the zone and have everybody come up and make the tackle.
They get it snapped with 1 second left on the play clock. Richard finds the soft spot. That's E.J. Hicks. E.J. Hicks, who has been the favorite target tonight, among them for Davius Richard, keeps this drive alive.
And the frustration from defensive coordinator Antoine Sewell. You have to blitz it because this is too much time. For a quarterback that's throwing darts, I mean, look at how much time he has to get rid of that football. Throws a strike, accurate throw across the field. That's why Morgan State's blitzing him, because they can't get pressure on him, and Richard has the ability to pick him apart.
24-yard pickup on that pass. Final minute of the opening quarter. Mookie Collier trying to run behind that left side of Corey Bullock and Zai Simpson, and a gain of 8 on 1st down.
I mean, this offensive line is having their way right now. I mean, the pass protection's been great, and then they're starting to force their will in the running game. It's a solid group up front. Good look at Daquan Thomas. Good to see him back in the game. And Robert Mitchell, Simpkins, the center, Ty Simpson, and Corey Bullock. It's a good group up front. They protect their quarterback, and they can get some push off the ball.
Game clock and play clock nearly match. The final play of the quarter, and it's Collier straight up ahead, and there's big number 0, Elijah Williams, along with others, as we come to the end of the quarter. Well, the Eagles coming in with a 4-1 record, opening MEAC play from home. They're on top after 1, 14-7 here in Durham.
Are you ready for football? No, really, are you? Are you screaming for football? Freezing for football?
Oh yeah, I'm freezing my booper off.
And dreaming for football?
I love you, Josh Allen.
Are you crafting, parenting, naming your pets, and loosening up for football?
Kelsey catches cleanly in coverage. Kelsey catches cleanly in coverage.
Are you manifesting for football? Are you losing it for football? Are you
breaking up with me?
For football.
Oh.
Honey, she just said Rams.
Perfect pass, Patrick.
That's a good-looking brat.
Hootay.
Touchdown.
Are you dancing, flexing, feuding, jonesing, burrowing, and manning-ing for football? Are you prepping, bracing, and getting hyped for an all-new season of football? Good. Then you're ready.
When you're part of something bigger than yourself, it feels like all you ever do is win, win, win. And when that something is an HBCU, you know you can't help but win, win, win. So, as proud supporters of HBCU programs, we just can't lose.
Better ingredients, better pizza, better brace yourself, because this right here is a Papa John's Papa Bowl. No crust, just piping hot toppings and melty cheese in an oven-baked bowl. Better ingredients, better pizza, now in a bowl, Papa John's.
Think about the best night's sleep you've ever had. At Tempur-Pedic, we're dedicated to helping you sleep like that every night, so you get the deep, comfortable, undisturbed rest you deserve. For a limited time, save $300 on select Tempur-Pedic mattresses.
Do you have an invention idea but don't know what to do next?
Go to InventHelp.com to get started today. We have representatives nationwide who will explain the InventHelp process step by step. Over 10,000 patents have been secured through InventHelp's patent referral services. The InventHelp data bank includes thousands of companies who have agreed to review new ideas. We've been helping inventors since 1984. Let's help you next. Get started today. Go to InventHelp.com for free information.
Welcome back to ESPN College Football, presented by McDonald's. Start of the second quarter, 14-7 advantage for the home team, and a huge third down coming up for the Eagles, who have been successful all night long on third downs. 1 yard to gain. And the quarterback sneak up ahead. He keeps it. It's Davius Richard. It'll be very close depending upon the spot.
I thought he lost his footing. He might have slipped when he was trying to plant. We mentioned how strong he is. I don't think he was able to get his footing underneath him.
And they're saying it's fourth down. But with the strength of Richard and the way that your offense has been moving tonight, do you go for it here? Yeah, Jay, I think he did.
Lost his footing. Hey, it's conference play. Go for it. You have confidence in your offense. You're the number two team in college football. You have to think you can come up with a yard.
This time operating out of the shotgun, they hand it off and up ahead. And Mookie Collier is able to get a push up ahead.
Yeah, I think he got enough with that surge. How about that, though? How often do you see, talk about the strength. You saw Davius Richard trying to push the pile. Normally, as quarterbacks, we get away from that pile. But Richard, hey, I can bench just as much as some of these guys here. He's trying to push his running back forward at just enough yardage. Maybe.
What'd you say? What,
225? 25 times. Coaches had to tell him, slow down on the weights.
So they're coming out to measure here to see if North Carolina Central is going to be very close, but he gets it. So the drive keeps on going. 14 plays so far for North Carolina Central, and there's that.
That's the surge, but watch number 11 come in here and start pushing. He's trying to push this pile. Get up out of there. You're too valuable to your team, Davius Richard.
12th first down of the night for this North Carolina Central offense. Shift up to the left side, man in motion. The toss to Taylor Mosley, and Mosley is driven backward and had really nowhere to go, and that was snuffed out well by the defense for Morgan State.
Yeah, we called out Wooden earlier for being neutralized from the free safety position, but watch him do a good job of stringing this play along. Get to the outside shoulder. Great individual effort there by Wooden, not giving up leverage on a little jet sweep.
Second and goal from the 11-yard line of the Bears.
Watch Devin Smith, number 22, in the slot.
Richard looking, has a little real estate going to the right side. Can he get in? Yes! Davius Richard with two passing touchdowns, and now he picks one up with his legs.
Great decision-making. Drops back. He's waiting for the slot receiver come open, makes up his mind, becomes a foot race. I mean, he's out running some pretty quick defenders. That's the free safety, Caleb Coleman, number four. Richard able to get the angle and sustain it for the touchdown.
Olivio connects on the extra point, 21-7. But that was an impressive drive from North Carolina Central. 16 plays, more than 7 minutes taken off the clock, and they're up by two scores.
This season, Sling has the channel lineup to channel your college football.
so you can catch the Hail Marys, witness every miracle, see the big games and the bowl games for less. Channel your football with Sling TV.
You know what beats next day shipping? Getting it the same day. So shop Ace online and get free in-store or curbside pickup right in your neighborhood. Or get what you need delivered the very same day you order.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
My husband was killed. You asked me if I was staying here for revenge. Maybe it's justice.
Walker Independence. New series. Check your local listings for showtimes only on the CW.
You plan the perfect thank you with the promotional product experts at 4imprint, who attended to every detail. Did you get it right? You certainly did. For the right products printed perfectly, go to 4imprint.com. 4imprint. For certain.
Think you could relax? That you'd seen everything there was to see? Or have you realized the game has never been better? That is hockey.
Jay Walker, Tiffany Green back with you as NCCU up 21-7 over Morgan State. Another great drive put together by the Eagles offense. They've scored on all three to start off this ball game, as we saw the Bears respond on their last possession. Can they engineer a drive here? We saw Keith Jenkins with an electrifying 72-yard return that set that scoring drive up for the Bears, halted short here. But we talked in the open about Trey Oliver's Davius Richard, that's not Trey Oliver on the screen. He just walked by. However, I'll say this. Davius Richard and the way that he was able to put together drives, there is a calm. There is a confidence that we have seen out of this junior quarterback that has Trey Oliver, who there he is on the screen, playing some of their best football right now.
The leadership is there, and Richard played great in this game against Morgan last year, on pace to do better things. But right now, it goes back to it earlier. I want to see Morgan State 2022. Do they continue to fight? Maybe a shootout. Do you have enough weapons? Morgan has shown the ability to put some points on the board. And I'm sure Trey Oliver is well aware of that. But you have to give credit to the job he's doing. I mean, who would have thought North Carolina Central would be ranked as high as they are, winning the quality football games they've done this season.
Knocked off a top 25 opponent, even beat their rival as Carson Grant Baker is scrambling out of the pocket and avoids the pressure and gets positive yardage there, brings up third down. We talked about Morgan State from a season ago, just two wins. We were on the call for their first win in conference play since 2019 when they beat A&T. They were able to down Delaware State, got a win against Georgetown. But Damon Wilson feeling like this group is buying into the belief that they can win ball games. Third and 10 on time, and that one was in and out of the hands of Avery Jones. He just dropped that one.
Wow. I mean, the protection was there, right place to go with the football. Maybe get the ball up a little bit. Could have been thrown a little bit more accurate there. I mean, this is a curl route. You know, every quarterback in America throws a curl route. You aim for the number. Where does this ball go? Down at his ankles. Got to make that throw. You got to split that one on a curl route with the receiver coming right back towards you. And look at this is the punter right here.
Yeah.
short.
Muddy. Pound punter.
Hey, look, man.
He's going to muscle the ball down the field.
Hey, gets it done. Maybe he wanted a little bit more roll there, but Davius Richard and their offense coming back for NCCU when we return.
Mass General Brigham. When you need some of the brightest minds in medicine, this is a leading healthcare system with 5 nationally ranked hospitals, including 2 world-renowned academic medical centers. In Boston, where biotech innovates daily, and our doctors teach at Harvard Medical School, and the physicians doing the world-changing research are the ones providing care. There's only one Mass General Brigham.
This is it, the big interview. Don't be nervous. You took classes from Yale in your bedroom, earned certificates from Google on that crowded, slightly stinky train ride, and went to Duke in your pajamas. So don't stop now.
You ready?
You're more than ready. Jump over the giant metaphorical pit of doubt. With over 5,000 courses and degrees from world-class institutions on Coursera, learn without limits.
It's Eagle Pride amplified here in Durham, 21-7 advantage for NCCU, and it's also time now for Jay's Gimme 5.
All right, Eagles, I got you. How about this? The most popular, famous alums of North Carolina Central, my style, Herman Boone, head coach of T.C. Williams High School, remember the Titan. Wild Bill Hayes, people don't know, he graduated from North Carolina Central in the Black House Hall of Fame as a coach. Number 3, Congressman G.K. Butterfield, acting member of Congress, he's a graduate here. Number 2, first black mayor of the city of Atlanta was Maynard Jackson, who graduated from North Carolina Central. And we'll come back to number 1 because we got to give him his due. And you talk about Sam Jones.
All right, Sam Jones. We'll learn more about him after this first play on offense for NCCU. Their best starting field position is Jamari Taylor on the carry. All right, back to Sam Jones.
Yeah, you got
to
give Sam Jones. He played for the Boston Celtics, won a number of championships there in the Pro Basketball Hall of Fame. And on the bump, I got Mike Easley, the former governor of North Carolina. That's my Gimme 5. We can hit it up online. Give me Tiff's 2 cents. What's that miss?
Tiff's 2 cents. You're talking about basketball. How about Lavelle Moten, one of the best to come through and play at NCCU? He is the men's basketball coach. He's won a number of championships with his squad. And then Sunshine Anderson, the recording artist.
Heard it all before?
Heard it all before. You know, we got to get a song in there any way that we can. I like the list, Jay. I like the list. We'll see if others agree as Richard has the pass incomplete. Kyle Morgan was the intended target.
Scouting report says he's a better blocker than he is receiver. And unfortunately tonight, Kyle Morgan has not been able to catch the football. 2 very catchable passes. Look at that. That's leadership there. I'm going to come back to you. You know, he said, hey, you dropped it, but I'm going to come back to you. Keep your head up. I'm going to need you to make some run blocks later. I may not throw you the ball, but I may need you to help me in pass protection or run blocking.
5 for 6 on third downs for NCCU. Remember, Oregon State got that stop, but the Eagles going for it on fourth down, and they were able to punch it in from there. And on 3rd and 7, zipped it right in to E.J. Hicks. Hicks is just a yard short of that first down marker.
I think you go for it. Even though it's a yard short, they brought the pressure. We're seeing the blitz come. Great recognition by Davius Richard, but came a yard short.
And also bringing 2 tight ends in with Luke Bracey and Kyle Morgan. So Kyle Morgan can redeem himself if they run towards his side and help in that run block.
Yeah, we're not going to throw you the ball, but we'll let you run block. They go to the hard count here, try and get them to jump off sides.
We can hear you! We can hear you!
And Richard, who had nowhere to go, bounces off and then breaks away across the 20, 10, and into the end zone. Second rushing touchdown of the night for Richard. What looked like a home and a stop for the Morgan State defense, and the back-breaking 42-yard run from Davius Richard on fourth and one.
How did he get out of there? I mean, that play was bottled up. You have to be frustrated for your defensive coordinator, Antoine Sewell from Morgan State. You called the perfect defense, but the athleticism of Richard turned it into a long touchdown crusher.
We've talked all night about the strength of Davius Richard. His coaching says, look, he has a way of breaking tackles and avoiding contact. And here, he's just showing his strength right here.
Just missed tackle there. I mean, he was bottled up. They had the play snipped out perfectly. It was a quarterback sweep right, but over pursuit, not tackling, not wrapping. Davius Richard was off to the races. When you saw number four miss that tackle, he's that nickel back for you. He's a guy that has to set the edge. If he gets out of place, then bad things can happen. But where were the safeties? Too much over pursuit. You have to play assignment football, and the Eagles made him pay.
How about the student section coming out tonight?
Who's that?
Thursday night. I'm not exactly
Dude got
sure.
A big head. Oh, that's a mascot. Okay.
I thought you were talking about yourself, man. I thought you saw yourself.
I have a big brain, not a big head.
Oh, boy.
I have a big brain.
Here we go. Here we go. 28-7 lead for North Carolina Central. Four drives, four touchdowns for the Eagles. Keith Jenkins to return it from the Bears, for the Bears. Across the 20, 25, 30. Has a move on the right side. And he turned on the Jets. Nobody's going to catch him. Keith Jenkins answering right back. 96 yards to the house. And Morgan State saying, hold up and wait a minute. We've got a flag on the field. But that's got to be likely celebration because that looked clean.
Oh, yeah. It came in the end zone as well. So obviously some type of celebration. But, you know, that's where you have to have the discipline. He wants to talk to him. Hey, what'd you do that for? You know, why do you get, you know, some type of penalty like that? Great run, though. He hit the afterburner, didn't he?
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, offense number 14. A 15-yard penalty would be enforced on the kickoff. This is number 14's first foul towards disqualification.
Now, Jay, this is what he was penalized for as he just did, like, yeah, you know, the lean forward, like you're on a track.
You know, that's one of those... That's one of those banned moves now they've got.
Or maybe it was the spin right there at the end.
Spin.
Yeah.
I mean, God, you can't call it for spin. Well, you rather spike the ball and, but miss extra point, which keep an eye on that as well.
Let's take another look at it here. The true freshman, you said last time he needed to finish off the punt. Well, this time he says, I'm going to finish off this kickoff return.
I'm going to find an extra gear and outrun everybody. And did a little bob there at the end. And got the unsportsmanlike. I mean, but he showed he's got some speed.
Well, again, some of the change that we're seeing from this Morgan State team from a season ago who only racked up one win in conference play. But right now, Damon Wilson has his group fighting on the road, trying to pick up their first conference victory. Remember, they were down 24-0 against Norfolk State last week, and then scored 21 unanswered points. And now Keith Jenkins tonight, you see that stat line for him, 3 returns, 200 yards. And the longest return for a kickoff for a touchdown since 2013.
Tip, look where they have to kick off from there.
Yeah.
From the 20, because of the bring attention to myself, want to spin that ball, I mean, you know, that's like, you know, you can't spike a ball, stuff like that. The spin, too much attention to self. And then, look, this is going to get worse if the ball goes out of bounds.
Yep.
Wow.
So, giving all types of
free kick out of bounds, kicking team, number 39. It's going to be a 5-yard penalty and free kick.
See? So now they're going to kick this ball off from the 15-yard line. And against North Carolina Central, whose offense you've struggled with all night.
But not only that, you know, we've seen E.J. Hicks be good in the return game. We'll see what Mosley can do along with his up man. There's Christian Mosley, because Mosley has some great speed there as well.
Morgan State's going to be hard-pressed to stop North Carolina Central from getting this ball at midfield, somewhere around the 50-yard line, which is great field position, particularly when you got a quarterback that's on fire in Davis Richard.
Right into the hands of Chris Mosley. Mosley across the 35, 40, little juke move, and then tripped up just near the 50-yard line, just as you mentioned, a 23-yard return. Right now, Davis Richard and this offense having a great night of football. And you think about what he did against Morgan State last season, 242 yards through the air, 4 total touchdowns. He's already gotten that number in the first half and still plenty of time remaining.
Yeah, just figure that once you count the rushing yards in there, over 240 yards of total offense and basically a quarter, not even a quarter and a half, and much more to go, on pace for a career night.
Willis Hicks, when you think about the way North Carolina Central started this season, we mentioned the win in that Duke's Mayo Classic over North Carolina A&T, and then they run off 3 straight more wins with 40 points or more. That was the first time they've done that in 37 years. So Trey Oliver's offense really gelling. Again, tripped up last weekend or a couple weekends ago against Campbell. However, this offense seems to be in sync.
Look at the quality of those wins. I mean, you beat North Carolina A&T, who's in the Big South.
And how about Mookie Collier on that left side, trying to beat the defender, sheds him, and just stops short as coming in to make the tackle is number 36. And boy, Mookie Collier
gets to the edge. The offensive line is winning their battles, and then just a poor job of open field tackling by George Tolles. Cost him some more yardage. But they got a good running back. Seen a good quarterback. Seen some decent wide receivers. Seen a great offensive line. There's a reason why this offense is averaging 38 points a game.
Now first and goal. They hand it back to Collier. And Collier is in for the touchdown. The cutback for Mookie, the redshirt junior out of Bluefield, West Virginia. Runs it in from 6 yards out.
Can't stop him. Watch him cut on a dime. Cut. Get here in the middle, small space. Cut. Made him whiff. It's Quincy Johnson, number 36, the freshman safety. Got caught in the jukebox and got juked.
With 8:46 to go in the first half, it's Mookie Collier who's able to tack on some more insurance. 35-13 against TCU.
It's a beautiful time for basketball. A season fresh with hope and stars vying for greatness. Heated rivalries with MVP talent. NBA opening week begins Wednesday and continues Friday on ESPN.
Do you have a...
think this goat is saying gap.
Must be talking about expenses health insurance doesn't cover.
Aflac!
Get help with expenses health insurance doesn't cover.
Aflac
is an official sponsor of ESPN College Game Day.
The game has never been better. That is hockey.
Want to go head-to-head with the Heismans? Get in on the action at theheismanhouse.com.
Tell me what I've done to you.
I just don't.
The NCCU Sound Machine playing good rhythms, good vibes from O'Kelly Riddick Stadium here at North Carolina Central. It's been a dominant first half for the Eagles, and in case you're wondering about the bands, you can see them in their entirety over on ESPN3. Jordan Toles, who bobbled the ball, was quickly met as the coverage team able to get down the field and pinning Morgan State back deep into their own territory. Well, I'll tell you this. I'm not sure if it's a function necessarily of the North Carolina Central defense or the Morgan State offense. Just 8 plays run this entire game for the Bears. They've only had the ball a little over 3.5 minutes.
And special teams helped them. They've got a couple good returns with that short field. 13 points at this point in the game, not bad for an offense that only averages 23. So they're on pace to do that, but I don't know if they were prepared to get to a shootout against a red-hot offense.
Alfonso Graham, who's bottled up pretty quickly, gain of 2. Remember, he's the MEAC leading rusher coming into tonight.
Get him the ball in space. I mean, he's a targeted guy, so I thought they had success when they did the play action to him. That's where they got the touchdown score from. But get him the ball outside of the tackles. There are too many black jerseys in the tackle box.
On 2nd and 8, going outside. One-on-one coverage. And Tyler Wilkins had a shot at it, but good defense played.
This
on
was
the outside, but yeah.
I mean, look at the throw. Look at the location of the throw. I say, run down there 40 yards, look up, ball's going to be in your right pocket. He put it in the right pocket. I mean, big-time throw on the timing route from Carson Baker. Wilkins just not able to secure the catch.
Student section turning up here on 3rd and 8.
Defense! Defense!
Baker feeling pressure, trying to get away from Jayden Taylor, and the pass is completed.
Wow, what a catch.
What a great catch by Damon Hamler, and it's a first down. Wow, great concentration from the wide receiver.
Yeah, I mean, playing with fire. I thought he was going to get tripped up from the back and the ball would have sailed. A little bit high, but a good job of great concentration after losing the football. It's a good job coming over by Khalil Baker to try and knock it loose, but great concentration by Hamler.
Converting on their second. First down, and now Alfonso Graham carrying a pile up ahead. And another strong run there. So back-to-back good plays of 10 yards or more. That was a gain of 11 from Graham.
Yeah, and get him going. Get him going in this game. This point in the game, you don't want to get away from me, so you have to go with your original game plan. Heavy dose of Graham and some timely passes from Carson Baker.
They feed the rock to number 2. 2 remains patient, and Graham is brought down near midfield, a gain of 6. It was Khalil Baker on the stop.
Nice patience there. Didn't look like he was going to find a seam. But you saw the patience and you saw the quick burst. And it did not take him long to go from 0 to picking up 6 yards in a hurry.
Remember, he averaged nearly 9 yards a carry against the Spartan defense last weekend, trying to pick up some momentum and gain some success against the Eagles as a flag comes out.
Personal foul. Face mask, defense, number 50. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
And it goes against the true freshman, Thomas Johnson.
Big break for Morgan State. I mean, the two personal fouls we've seen called this contest earlier have gone against the Bears. North Carolina Central gets called for a penalty to keep the most impressive drive of the night in terms of number of plays and distance alive.
Rolling right and into the hands of Alfonso Graham. Wow, wonderful catch by Alfonso Graham, who showed off great hands and just tracking that ball in.
He went to go get this ball. I mean, I almost thought it was a throwaway pass, and he kicked into a gear and caught that on his fingertips for the first down conversion.
Well, BT Sherman, the offensive coordinator, talked about how much he loves the top-end speed that Alfonso Graham has. A physical back who just uses his 5'9 frame to be as crafty as possible here, patiently running behind, pulling guard, and gain of a few.
And when you watch Graham run, got a little bit of classic Le'Veon Bell with the way he moves his feet to show the patience, set up the run. You know, not the big guy that Bell is, but he waits patiently and he finds a crease and doesn't need much room to strike.
That one was nearly picked off, thrown in some traffic as Khalil Baker, free safety, had a good look at it.
Yeah, have to find someplace else to go with the football. You'll see two black jerseys there with an opportunity. Isaiah Lawson, the Mike linebacker, was buzzing underneath, and Khalil Baker from his free safety position was all over that one. Fortunate to still have possession of the football.
10th play of the drive coming up here. Third down for the Bears. Baker quickly gets it out. Crowley, who caught a touchdown earlier, stopped short of the first down.
They brought the pressure again, and good reaction. Open field tackle by Isaiah Lawson from that linebacker position. Had to make an open field tackle and able to make it. Whoa.
Going for it here on 4th and 2. 4 for 10 on the season. On 4th downs, Graham and Jabril Johnson in the backfield. And they hand it off to Graham, and Graham has stood up as Jaden Taylor meets him, and the hold from the defense from NCCU, turnover on downs.
They rolled the dice, going for it. Can't blame the decision to go for it. When you're down by 22, you know you're in the chase position. Your defense hasn't been able to get a stop. But there is just nowhere to go. And that's a great job of playing the position by Jaden Taylor. They say he's got a quick first step, could be disruptive in the pass game, but that was a great run play on the run stop.
Now NCCU takes over at their own 18-yard line.
The right side of the line was getting a running start before the ball snapped.
I'll start. Offense, number 71, 5-yard penalty, first down.
If Morgan State defensively cannot get a stop on this drive right now, they cannot keep North Carolina Central to just 35 points at the half, it's over. This game's over. I mean, they have to get a stop. They have not forced a punt. Every drive has been touchdown. Now they got to go the length of the field, 4-minute offense. You have to show that you're going to be able to slow down this offense from North Carolina Central.
They were able to bottle up Collier. We'll bring up second down. Well, this is a North Carolina Central team that was picked to finish second in the preseason behind the HBCU national champions, South Carolina. Carolina State winning that cricket celebration bowl. But remember, it was NCCU who found their way in Atlanta back in 2016. Coming up short, but the Eagles are hungry to try to win the MEAC this year and be the representative. On second and 15. Pressure coming. Davius Richard feels it sinked and thrown to the ground by Elijah Williams. So great defensive play and making Richard feel it a little bit.
Yeah, this is what you want. I mean, wow, that was an aggressive tackle. That was Tom Brady. They would have called a penalty. But we talked about Elijah Williams able to win his battle. And he was a quarterback. You hate when you're in no man's land like that. A nice inside move against Simpson. And see, they got the stop they needed, maybe. Get the ball back, and then you've got a little momentum, something to build upon in the second half. So give credit to this Bear defense is stepping up the previous two plays. Don't hurt yourself. You know, you can get the stop, but if you make the tackle short, watch the taunting penalties. We know the officials are calling it real tight, the unsportsmanlike conduct. Nothing to help give this Central offense a second chance.
So 3:16 remaining and
get the stop.
Get the stop here. This would be huge for Morgan State. Richard looking, pass incomplete, and that'll bring up fourth down. First punt of the night for NCCU. So credit Morgan State's defense, and Elijah Williams was the reason.
Yeah, and some good things to get going from right now. This is not going to be an easy punt because North Carolina Central's backed up. So the opportunity for maybe a punt block is there. Your return guy, you want to tell him, if we're going punt block, all I need you to do is field the ball. We've got great field position. So, and Central threw a pass, so the clock stopped. So you're going to have time to try and get some points on the board going into the locker room.
Florida in the back of his end zone before the snap, a timeout taken by NCCU. And we will step aside as well. Fourth down coming up here from Durham.
Did you expect?
Did you think you could relax?
Saved by Shesterkin.
Or had you convinced yourself some records were forever? That you'd seen everything there was to see? Or have you realized you can't look away and you don't know the future and that the game has never been better? That is hockey.
For more than 150 years, Morgan State University has positioned its graduates to grow the future and lead the world. Morgan students receive a world-class education, engage in meaningful research, and uplift their communities. Over 126 programs conveniently available online or on Morgan's beautiful campus. Designated the national treasure, there's something for everyone. Pursue your purpose. Progress in your passions. Achieve the promise of career fulfillment. Your Morgan experience awaits. Choose Morgan.
A job well done deserves the perfect thank you. So you plan that thank you thinking of every detail with the promotional product experts at 4imprint. They had the items you were looking for, printed your logo perfectly, and guaranteed your order would arrive on time. And now, did you get it right? You most certainly did. When the moment needs to be just right, go to 4imprint.com. 4imprint, for certain.
MEAC conference opener for North Carolina Central. They have a 35-13 advantage, but Morgan State's defense forcing the first three and out of the night as Juan Velarde in the back of his end zone, ready to punt it out. Andre Crawley is standing by, awaiting the punt.
If you're going for punt block, they're setting up a punt return. They're setting up the return, and what a punt.
Great punt by Velarde, and fair caught at midfield or near there for the Bears. Well, this Saturday, this is the first of our two featured college football games on ABC, a massive Big 12 showdown between Oklahoma State and TCU. That's at 3:30. Then coming your way later that night, Saturday night football game presented by Capital One. It's the fourth-ranked Clemson Tigers, who are 6-0 and will be in terms of taking on Florida State. The 6-0 Tigers going to Dope Campbell Stadium. That game kicking off at 7:30 Eastern.
You got to help me out here.
Okay.
Going in, we said, if you're going to go for the block on the punt, I'm just going back to the punt. The football mind is clicking right now.
Okay.
If you're going to go for the punt block, you tell your return guy nobody's blocking for you for your catch. If you're setting up return, then you catch it and run, pick up yards. I mean, it's little things like that. 7-8 yards make a difference before the half. They're leaving yardage out there. I mean, right there, you know, the back, Johnson, was open in the flat. You throw him into the sideline, so instead of him picking up a first down, he has to settle for a 3-yard. The great teams do the little things, make it look easy, efficient. Right now we're seeing Morgan struggle with some of the little things, the fine details of the game.
And Morgan State's head coach, Damon Wilson, will be the first to tell you we're still building that culture, you know, still trying to, again, instill that winning mindset into this group. And it first starts with belief, but you're talking about those little details here on 3rd and 6, just over 2 minutes to go in this first half, and the pass incomplete to Crawley.
Yeah, and now all of a sudden you go from a great opportunity to have momentum to you got to punt the football. And you got to give the ball to Davius Richard one more time before the half. After the defense got the stop, they just couldn't get it going. I mean, that third down pass should have been caught if Baker has a little bit more patience and allows the receiver to finish the top of the route.
So the punting unit back on for Morgan State. And E.J. Hicks with the fair catch. Well, coming up on our Twisted Tee halftime report, Zubin Mahinty and Sam Acho in the studio will have a look at Sam's film room. We'll preview Penn State, Michigan, and of course we'll talk that Oklahoma State TCU game as well. College football coaching carousel, that's all coming up at the half. And just a reminder to our viewers, you can watch the halftime performances of the bands here tonight as Morgan State's magnificent marching machine made their way from Baltimore down this way. So you can see it over on ESPN3 without interruption, along with the NCCU sound machine. The run here from Collier, and Collier with the speed breaking through tackles, and then a flag coming out at the end and a face mask.
So that'll be more yardage that you tack on, and it just seems like Morgan State missed that opportunity when they got the stop. And now,
personal foul, face mask, defense, number 23. 15 yards be added to the end of the run. First down.
And now I just get the feeling that Trey Oliver's going to tell Matt Leone, step on the gas. Let's get some points before the half. Try and put this game away at halftime. We see the face mask coming here, but good hard running from Latrell Collier. Mookie.
Richard back to pass on first down. Has a man. And that's Andrew Smith. Smith into Bears territory. appears to be Daquan Thomas coming up limping. Let's look back at that play.
Look at that pocket. That is too clean of a pocket for a quarterback, a good quarterback, to have. You know, and you've got number 40, Eric Hunter, the inside linebacker, playing drop chase. Well, he can only drop so far before he has to look in the backfield. That pocket's just too clean. I mean, you got guys running downfield. Quarterback is feeling it. The defensive line for Morgan State has not made an impact in this game. Outside of Williams. One man bad out there, zero.
Fourth trip to the red zone for NCCU, and Collier just picking up hard-fought yards. 12 carries, 101 yards on the night for Latrell Collier, and add a touchdown to that as well. NCCU trying to punch it in one more time before going into the locker room. Collier towards that left side, stuffed. And so NCCU with one timeout remaining.
Good time to call a timeout here. All right, can I start something? So we've seen a lot of games this year, right?
And Carolina Central.
We're just third getting final into our MEAC part of the schedule, seconds. Right? You know, we got a MEAC game coming up tonight, and we'll see how this weekend. Who have we seen the most this year?
Jackson State.
Number one ranked team. Mm-hmm. This is probably the cleanest half of football I've seen any HBCU play. And everybody wants to know, you know, that Cricket Celebration Bowl, Central's the front runner to be there, even though they still have to play South Carolina State a week now. But when you see them in person, I mean, I'm starting to imagine, like, man, that Jackson State versus North Carolina Central, if it plays out and they handle their business on the field, woo!
Yeah. Could be a great one. And look, the MEAC has had
five or six.
The upper hand
five
in the Cricket Celebration Bowl. It has been lopsided for sure as the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference has won 5 of 6. And now North Carolina Central, this is the critical part of their season. Conference play starting tonight for them. They're looking to make a statement. And Davius Richard.
Too easy.
Finds Devin Smith. And yes, the statement made. The Durham native with his second touchdown catch of the night.
I mean, the good teams make the simple things look easy. That looks like just throwing and catching. It looks like a pitcher playing warm-up pitches with his catcher. When you're in the groove, that's how it feels.
Well, one of the things that Davius Richard and Devin Smith did over the summer, holding camps for the youth in the area, but also it was Davius Richard who made a point to reach out to his wide receivers and say, let's take some time. Let's get in rhythm. Let's develop a chemistry so that when we come in season, we do just this right here.
Yep. I mean, trusting his wide receiver, knowing the spot to get to without the pressure there. He knows all I have to do is just find the right location for the football. He'd almost make that throw with his eyes closed. You know, I actually used to practice that.
Oh, really?
Me and Flea? Because I used to hear that. I heard, like, Roger Clemens say I could throw strikes with my eyes closed. Mm-hmm. I said, well, I wonder if I can complete pass with my eyes closed. And, you don't do it in the game situation, but that's when you know you've got that groove. But let's take a look at top two teams in HBCU football are Jackson State and North Carolina Central. Mm-hmm. Shador Sanders. I told you, when you got a quarterback and he's better than the other team's quarterback, most times you're going to win. I think that's why we're seeing Central success. Two of the best quarterbacks in FCS football are leading their teams, looking very good this early in the season.
Near the midway point of the season, so still plenty to play out. And when you think about Jackson State undefeated in the SWAC, North Carolina Central 4-1, looking to hold tight to this lead. And they have another half of football to play to try to pick up their first conference win of the season, but Trey Oliver knows that this bunch wants to be great. They want to vie for that number one spot, as they came up just short last year after they closed out the season really strong with 3 straight wins.
think, you know, the key is now you're thinking, if I'm Morgan, I want to get to the locker room. And Damon Wilson, the first-year head coach, I mean, I think most coaches know it. Once he gets his guys in there, that, you know, this team will do even better in bigger games like that. They've shown signs of life. I believe they get the ball back to start the second half, so they got to be thinking, we got to score that opening drive to cut this lead.
Carson Baker steps up, tries to sling it in there, and the pass incomplete, third down.
What I like to see for Morgan today, they got big bodies. I mean, at the wide receiver position, you know, they've got 6'3", 6'3", 6'2". Crawley is 5'7", when he's a scat back. Start getting the ball to some of those big guys on the outside and challenge the secondary of North Carolina Central to see if they can make tackles. And that wasn't the case versus Campbell a week ago. There was some poor tackling that put them behind early. That would be my recommendation for a second-half adjustment.
They hand it off to Jabril Johnson, and that will take us to the end of the half. 42 points put up by the Eagles through two quarters on the visiting Morgan State Bears, and Trey Oliver again sees his team eclipse 40 or more points, but first time they've done it in a half since 2016. Jay, your thoughts on that performance so far from NCCU?
I mean, impressive, dominating, and they're the number two ranked HBCU in my power rankings for a reason. Complete ball squad. They're clicking on all cylinders. That was impressive. And I told America Davis Richard was good. Whether or not you believe me was up to you. But I think after that first half performance, you have to know the green-eyed bandit is the real deal.
12 of 17, 174 yards accounted for four touchdowns himself, 42-13 after two.
So?
The new iPhone 14 Pro. It's amazing.
Yep, the camera is incredible. And you'll get our best deal.
Nice. But everyone should get it.
Everyone can get it.
Every new customer.
And every existing customer.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Okay, my work here is done. Everyone gets the best deal on every iPhone.
Best one yet.
Everyone gets AT&T's best deals on every iPhone, including up to $800 off iPhone 14 Pro.
Are you coming for my job?
It all started when we showed up in Austin waving a Wazoo flag, trying to get game day to come to Pullman. Then it kind of became an obsession. I'm Tom Pounds, and this is the story of the Cougar that wouldn't quit. We flew Old Crimson at every game day. And after 15 years, game day finally came to Washington State. And I lost my mind. Now we keep doing it because game day isn't just a day, it's a lifestyle.
Race car driver.
Watching the Twisted Tea Halftime Report.
And inside the college football studio with Sam Acho and Zubin Mehenti, there are some people that are saying this is going to be the biggest college football Saturday yet. And it's hard to argue when you take a look at the list of games on tap, including a couple of incredible top 10 matchups. One in the SEC, College Game Day for the second time this season will be in Knoxville. They're saying this could be the biggest game at Neyland Stadium in years, with Alabama coming to town. And there's a huge Big Ten East showdown between Penn State and Michigan, and that's the subject of Sam's film room.
Michigan's going to try and run the ball. Penn State's going to try and stop them. Thankfully, they have a dude by the name of P.J. Mustafford. This dude is smart. He's physical. He's attacking. He also describes their entire defense. Check out this play. You're going to see a defensive tackle, P.J. Mustafford, standing up. He knows what's happening. He's listening to the offense check. There's no better feeling than to know what's going to happen, than to dominate the guy in front of you, and then to make the play. Very smart play. He's a smart player. But this defense is also very physical. You're going to see Abdul Carter on this next play come down from this linebacker position and make a huge play in the opponent's territory. There's no better feeling. But it's not just him. This defense is also attacking. Now we got a safety, Jair Brown, in the box again, getting in the backfield. This is consistently what a Manny Diaz coach defense does. They live in the backfield, and it brings this certain type of energy for your defense. Now, it's going to be difficult. Blake Corum, the last three games, has 500 yards. That's a lot. The game before that, he ran for 5 touchdowns. But I believe that P.J. Mustafford in this defense can hold Blake Corum down and try and find a way to win.
That's a big litmus test in the Big Ten East. This game could go a long way to determining who plays in the Big 12 championship game. Oklahoma State and TCU. I mean, it's not out of the question they could actually meet again for the championship. It's Saturday at 3:30 Eastern on your local ABC station. Sam has made the long trek back, the 20 feet away from the film room, to rejoin me on the set. Thanks for not leaving me hanging here. All right, so big spot here, your analysis of the Pokes and the Frogs. Huge showdown in Fort Worth.
TCU's offense has been amazing. And it's not my opinion. Like, statistically, they're the number one. They're tied for number one in yards per play, averaging over 8 yards per play. And what stands out to me is their big play ability. Max Duggan is playing fearless. You're going to see guys like Tay Barber making plays, guys like Darius Davis, guys like Quentin Johnston making plays. And you see this kind of fearless attack because Max Duggan doesn't care anymore. He wasn't starting at the beginning of the season. He got his starting spot back. Even last week against Kansas, this team went blow for blow. That catch was the game-winning touchdown with 1:20 left. Yes, we saw what TCU did against Oklahoma. It was not a fluke. They did the same thing last week, and it seems they're going to do the same thing all season long.
It'll be interesting because you got old Mike Gundy, who's been there forever, and brand new Sonny Dykes, and both have continued to do an outstanding job. For the second time this season, as I mentioned, College Game Day is going to be at Neyland Stadium at the University of Tennessee. Alabama and Tennessee, I heard former Georgia quarterback Aaron Murray say on ESPN2 last night, this is the biggest game Tennessee has played in 20 years. And who will be the celebrity picker? Hard to top Bianca Belair.
This halftime report is presented by the refreshing taste of Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Please drink responsibly.
We're turning up the tailgate with a Twisted Tea drop. Surprising real Twisted Tea fans who love the smooth and refreshing taste of Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea with a 5% kick of alcohol. Twisted Tea tastes like real iced tea because it's made with real fruit tea. Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Keep it twisted.
Hi, Phil Swift here. Before winter storms hit, get prepared with the Flex Seal family of products. A deep freeze can cause pipes to crack, but Flex Tape can easily patch those busted pipes. And when snow and ice thaw, it can leave behind even more damage. But Flex Paste can fill large cracks to seal out water. Flex Glue your old snow boots so they can make it through another season. Use on RVs and campers to help seal cracks and prepare for winter. Now you can make fast repairs even in the coldest temperatures. Stop cold drafts and insulate your home by sealing up windows and doors. Heavy ice and snow can cause major damage. But with the Flex Seal family of products, it's easy to make quick repairs, even in the toughest conditions. When winter's at its worst, Flex Seal's at its best. Make the FlexSeal family part of your winter storm kit. FlexSeal, because it works.
This is El Clasico.
Thousands of games, including the one you won. That is hockey. Live NHL games from every team. Home and away games when you're away from home. That is hockey. The moments no one has but us. The plays no one has but us. That is hockey on ESPN Plus.
It's a beautiful time for basketball. NBA opening week begins Wednesday and continues Friday on ESPN.
You're watching the Twisted Tea Halftime Report.
You know, there's an old adage in sports. Coaches are hired to be fired. Head coaches are hired to be fired. So where did that leave interim coaches? Actually, in a much better position than you might think.
The college football carousel is spinning faster than ever. Used to be your record was evaluated at the end of the year. Now a single bad Saturday sends fans into a frenzy, and there's no more dubious title than interim head coach. After all, the idea is a clean break from the past, not a continuation of it. Though something funny happened last week. The placeholders at Wisconsin, Arizona State, Georgia Tech, and Nebraska all won. Who says all hope is lost? After rushing for 2 yards and a lopsided loss to former Wisconsin coach Brett Bielema, the Badgers fired Paul Christ. 7+ years, 7 bowls, including a rose, but the bloom was off it. Jim Leonard, a former Badger superstar, stepped in and delivered a 42-7 win over Northwestern in his first game. Up next, a trip to East Lansing, Saturday. The key to Georgia Tech might be Brent Key. The Yellow Jackets were non-competitive in each of Jeff Collins' first 4 games this season, but the former Georgia Tech team captain has rallied them to 2 wins in as many games, both tight wins, Pittsburgh and Duke, each of the last 2 Saturdays. And a week from tonight, they're back in action against Virginia, squarely in the chase for the Coastal. Sean Aguano may have had the biggest interim win of the week, leading Arizona State over then nationally ranked Washington. Now comes a bye and a trip to reeling Stanford. Lastly, the proudest program of the group, the Cornhuskers, gave former quarterback turned interim Mickey Joseph a winning record, squeaking past Rutgers on the way to West Lafayette Saturday, with the Big Ten West title very much in play. How many Saturdays are left for these guys beyond this season? That remains unknown. But each is now a known commodity and making a case for themselves as the possible answer.
What's the answer going to be for Russell Wilson to turn this thing around? Broncos, Chargers, Monday night from SoFi on ESPN and ESPN Deportes. Twisted Tea, Halftime Report.
All right, team. We got a big project coming up. And it all starts with ordering promotional products.
I'm on it.
4imprint makes it easy to get the logoed products you're looking for. The latest in apparel, drinkware, bags, high-tech items, and more. You can be certain of getting it right at 4imprint.com.
Come on out. I'm on it.
4imprint. For certain. Are you ready for football? No, really. Are you? Are you screaming for football? Freezing for football?
Oh, yeah, I'm freezing my blooper off.
And dreaming for football?
I love you, Josh Allen.
Are you crafting, parenting, naming your pets, and loosening up for football?
Kelsey catches cleanly in coverage.
Are you manifesting for football? Are you losing it for football? Are you
breaking up with me?
For football.
Oh.
Honey, she just said Rams.
Perfect pass, Patrick.
That's a good-looking brat.
Hooray.
Touchdown.
Are you dancing, flexing, feuding, jonesing, burrowing, and Manning-ing for football?
Unbelievable.
Are you prepping, bracing, and getting hyped for an all-new season of football? Good. Then you're ready.
The future.
On a patronizing Fansville by Dr. Pepper.
That's called an off tackle. That's where the running back runs.
I know what it is. Did you just fansplain me?
I'm sorry. I was out of bounds. That's where a player steps
back.
Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve. This halftime report is presented by the refreshing taste of Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Please drink responsibly.
A couple of news and notes on the injury front you need to know. Obviously, at the top of the list, Bryce Young, hopeful he can go Saturday. Jalen Daniels swatted down news that he was out for the season yesterday on his own. And a couple of other big-time quarterbacks to keep an eye on. KJ Jefferson out of the SEC and Devin Leary in the ACC. We'll see what happens on the road to Saturday. Second half's on the way. This has been the Twisted Tea Halftime Report.
Your grooming routine down, but you're not done until you take it to the max. Microtouch Titanium Max, the all-new micro precision trimmer that goes where no other grooming tool can to finish your look. With micro oscillating German stainless steel blades bonded with titanium,
it's incredible. It's the difference between having a good groom and then taking it to a great groom.
Eliminate that unibrow. Easily remove ear hair and nose hair. Gone. Snap on the comb to tame bushy eyebrows in seconds. And touch up mustaches, beards, and sideburns fast. No nicks, cuts, or irritation.
If you're not finishing your groom with Titanium Max, you're not grooming.
Get yours now at TitaniumMax.com for only $14.99. Or call 1-800-513-4711.
The Titanium Max is the way. It's the best trimmer I've ever used.
Microtouch Titanium Max, the finisher for the ultimate groom.
It's a beautiful time for basketball. A season fresh with hope and stars vying for greatness. Heated rivalries with MVP talent. NBA opening week begins Wednesday and continues Friday on ESPN.
An ABC doubleheader.
The battle of the Big 12 unbeaten.
Undefeated Clemson, the crucial Atlantic Coast Conference collision.
You have no idea what's going to happen on any given Saturday.
Oklahoma State, TCU. Clemson, Florida State. Saturday on ABC.
Welcome back to ESPN College Football presented by McDonald's. Fans inside O'Kelly Riddick Stadium here on the campus of North Carolina Central University see a 42-13 advantage at the half for the Eagles. We told you coming on air that these were
The top five teams, according to our Jay Walker, his power rankings, NCCU coming in at number two and right now showing off just why they are the second best team in all of HBCU football. As we say hello and welcome you back in with Jay Walker, I'm Tiffany Green. And if you're Trey Oliver, you have to be pleased with nearly a perfect half of football.
Yeah, I mean, offensively was really the where they showed their star power, their dominance at offensive line. The defense did a good job as well. Have to, you know, coaches always have to complain about some special teams a little bit shaky, but other than that, North Carolina Central looked like the number two ranked team in the country to me.
Well, we built this game as the Davius Richards Show. That's how it's been all season for North Carolina Central, and he has certainly shown up and showed out so far.
Yeah, Mr. Richard, thank you for inviting us to your party. I mean, you talk about throwing a party. He was phenomenal throwing the football, finding receivers. We saw the arm strength. We saw the ability to capitalize on the run and take advantage of what the defense was giving him. And then this play right here, he was just saying, I'm just the best athlete on the field right now. I mean, Davius Richard is putting it all on display. It's been a phenomenal first half. And pitching and catching, he's a good quarterback, and he's getting better. And I think tonight, America got to see why. I think he's one of the elite talents on the FCS level.
We look at the numbers that he's put up so far, 240 yards of total offense and a career best five total touchdowns, three through the air and two on the ground for Davius Richard. Meanwhile, when you look at Morgan State, if you're Damon Wilson, what do you say to your group at the half that has them coming out playing inspired football for the final two quarters?
Yeah, they've got to come out hot. I mean, they have to come out hot right now. I think coming out of locker room, I always say coaches really earn their paycheck. What type of second half adjustments do you make? They need to score quickly and then figure out a way to get the offense an opportunity to get on the field. Their defense has been on the field way too long. Central's been pushing them around. They've got to match that physicality.
Alfonso Graham, the MEAC's leading rusher, just 21 yards on the ground, correction, netting just 17 yards on eight carries tonight. The Bears will receive the ball first, and they have the opportunity to come out of the locker room and try to put some points on the board. On the return, here's Crawley. Crawley responsible for one of the touchdowns tonight for the Bears, just out to near the 30-yard line. Well, for the whopping numbers that we saw for NCCU, just 109 total yards of offense for the Bears. And Carson Baker, 7 of 15, 86 yards as he trots back onto the field with his unit.
Passing game has not really been efficient. And they've had open wide receivers, and they've just been on different pages. Drop ball here, receiver not getting his depth here. Inaccurate throw. Offensively, they have not put it together in this ball game.
Here's Alfonso Graham. They hand it off to him, shedding a couple of tackles and can't escape there from Ja'Kai Brevard. A gain of four. This group out of Baltimore made the drive here for a Thursday night game, about 4.5 hours or so from their campus. They're looking to pick up their first win in the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference.
Yeah, I think Morgan State football fans are ready for some excitement. They want to get back to competing, and it's been a long time coming. Just taking it on the chin tonight. Let's see if the boys from Maryland show some fight here in the second half.
Crawley with the first down, who is a Baltimore native, went to Mount St. Joseph. And a gain of eight. So the ball spotted at the 41. We're seeing a little bit quicker tempo from Morgan State coming out of the locker room as Baker decides to keep it, trying to find some free space and does so. So good run and pick up on first down. Gain of six.
Yeah, good job. I think at one point in the first quarter, they'd only had maybe six offensive plays total. So if they can get multiple first downs, maybe they're seeing some adjustments they can take advantage of in the second half. Offensive coordinator B.T. Sherman, one of the bright young minds in terms of offense, in a hot commodity. Let's see what he can come up with.
Second and four. Good run there from Alfonso Graham. And Graham, with a nice little burst there, bringing him down was Khalil Baker.
the patient run, then watch how quickly he accelerates. One cut. Right there. You come in there with a poor angle. Zakai Brevard made a great tackle on him earlier, but this time he missed. Graham made him pay.
21 yards later, longest rush of the night. They give it back to Graham again.
Who is this? I mean, this offensive line right now is dominating. I'm talking Marvin Atuiatasi, the right guard, number 58, pushing the pile. Number 76, Chris Anthony, pushing the pile, winning the battles interior, led by their vocal leader, Dexter Carr.
The pitch out to Graham. Graham fumbles it. It's on the field still, and North Carolina Central is able to come out with it. I'll tell you this. That is deflating. That's heartbreaking if you're Morgan State because you were moving the ball so well and just not able to handle the pitch, and Thomas Johnson comes up with it.
Yeah, most impressive drive of the night so far, picking up yards, but I just think Graham took his eye off the ball trying to set up a move on the defender or the would-be tackler.
Courtney Core to the left, the defensive coordinator, Trey Oliver to your right, both alums of North Carolina Central, and happy to be back here and building a brand of football that is winning.
Yeah, you know what they're talking about, though.
What's that?
Man, they moved that ball a little bit too easy. We got lucky. We dodged one. What are they doing? Let's not allow them to have that type of success the rest of this half.
Devin Smith, who is wrapped up quickly by Caleb Coleman. No gain on the play.
I actually thought that should have been a loss of yardage on that play. He caught the ball. That knee was obviously down. In college football, you're not allowed to get back up.
Well, Trey Oliver saw his offense move the ball with ease. They scored on 6 of 7 drives in that first half to put up 42 points. Richard finds Collier. And Collier with a short gain, but the combination of Davius Richard and the balanced running attack that we've seen from Collier, but he also has the ability to come out of the backfield and catch the ball as well. It's just been easy sailing so far.
Let's see if they kept some of that energy and some of that juice for the second half. They face third and eight because we know Morgan's going to have to make some adjustments defensively. Let's see if they work and can produce a 3-and-out.
Well, miscommunication there, so a hold for Morgan State's defense. We saw Davius Richard in this offense start 5 of 5 on third downs, and since then, Morgan State's defense 1 of 5. Good back down here from the Bears.
I'm trying to do it. Good recognition. If you can't get to the quarterback, leave your feet. Good job by Dindo, interior lineman from the Netherlands, i.e. American Samoa.
Velarde, just the second punt of the night, and Crawley with the fair catch. It keeps on bouncing for the Eagles before being down. Carson Baker and the Bears come back on offense when we return.
What did you expect?
Did you think you could relax? Or had you convinced yourself some records were forever? That you'd seen everything there was to see? Or have you realized you can't look away and you don't know the future and that the game has never been better? That is hockey.
Whatever. We've obtained documents revealing that Carl's Jr. and Hardee's have Charbroil double deals starting at $2.99 each.
Can I take a closer look? Oh, wow.
Bite into these double deals starting at $2.99 each at Carl's Jr. and Hardee's.
In 1 second, Sarah will get a job offer somewhere sunnier, relocating in weeks.
Weeks?
Yeah, weeks.
Got a solid house.
Don't worry. Sell to Open Door and move on your schedule.
Yes.
Request a cash offer at opendoor.com.
She looks so... Back here in Durham, 42-13 in favor of the home team. Jay Walker, Tiffany Green back with you. As we remind you that this Saturday, the first of two of our featured college football games on ABC, it's 13th ranked TCU hosting Oklahoma State. Then later that night, there's Florida State hosting Clemson. Two big games you can catch. Full weekend of college football. Tigers 6-0 for Dabo Swinney.
Nice pass play there to Crawley. North Carolina Central brought pressure, left the middle field open, right place to go with the football. We're seeing some life from this offense from Morgan State. Though it's early in the second half, let's see if they can protect the football and try and put some points on the board.
Baker with really nowhere to go, and he's bottled up Quintez Mansfield. Brings it down for the sack.
Yeah, man-to-man coverage. What we're seeing is North Carolina Central stacking the box. Man coverage, eight guys around the line of scrimmage. Nowhere to go with the football, but you have to have that clock going off.
Baker, again, having to scramble. Tosses it over, and Graham nearly got to it, but pass incomplete. That'll bring up third and long for the Bears.
He's trying to create some offense. Haven't been smooth all night. Good decision here. Pillow air, he was out of bounds as well. You see the official's hat came down, signaling that he was out of bounds, so it would have been a phenomenal. One thing I don't like about this Morgan offense, I like when they're getting ahead on first down and they're running the football, but it seems like their pass attack is a little bit all over the place, like relying on a scramble, like they're relying on busted plays to attack you.
Baker with plenty of time, and that one caught by Andre Crawley. And Crawley is right there at the sticks, and the question is it good enough for a first down? I think they're going to say.
Yeah, so here they got to get the depth. After you've got the sack that happened earlier in the set of downs, then you got to be looking for that secondary thing. You don't want to hit the crossing route. Throw the ball down the field. And when it comes up fourth and 10, then you obviously got to punt the ball away to try to pin them deep.
I was looking at the long spot on the field. Thank you there, partner. We talk about the winning tradition of North Carolina Central. You think back to the days of Ron Broadway.
Broadway actually won an HBCU national championship.
That's right. And some of the disciples of Rod Broadway were that guy right there, Trey Oliver, Courtney Core. Oliver, who then went on to be the D coordinator of Southern before taking over the job at his alma mater 3 seasons ago. And Collier with a quick burst and brought down by Elijah Williams after that gain of 7. Collier has had himself a nice night. 110 yards for the redshirt junior.
And we can talk so much about Davis Richard, but I like how you mentioned before, Collier played himself a good football game as well. These two in the backfield together, explosive.
to the outside, and Elijah Williams, we've seen that takedown technique a couple times tonight. Did it to Davius Richard back in that first half, and now to Collier, a loss of one.
Williams can be a difference maker, but the only problem is he seems to be the only one creating some havoc with that motor. Just a sophomore from New Jersey City, New Jersey. He's got the tools, 6'2", 260 pounds, and we've seen him impose his will a couple times. I like his versatility. Now they're going to move him up a little bit more inside, see if he can be disruptive with a matchup against a guard.
Richard with time and zips it over to Andrew Smith, and that'll move the sticks.
You don't see that too often. Call this a out route in college football. You don't see many of them. With a drive up to 10, come back to 7. You can drive 12, come back 7. Pick up the yardage there, and you really throw those type of comeback out routes when you've got a quarterback that's got a gun, a strong arm hose. We've seen Davis Richard display that tonight.
We saw Williams trot off the field for the Bears, who will make a play for them here as the handoff to Jamari Taylor. And Taylor, who's tackled by Lawrence Richardson,
like that,
at midfield.
I like that play call. Elijah Williams leaves the game. He plays right defensive end for Morgan State. What do? You run the ball right at their right defensive end, pick up some positive yardage on first down, testing the backup who's under the game. I believe that's Darius Outlaw.
And when you look at this backfield, remember the name Isaiah Totten?
Yes. He was only here for about 9 years.
Oh, yeah. We called his name for a number of years, and now there's a nice trio of running backs as Taylor somehow stays on his feet. And Taylor picks up the first down.
And where are they running the ball now? Elijah Williams out the game, so we've seen him make substitution. They brought in Asante to come in there and play some rush in, and different folks. They're just going to continue to run the ball on that side until you hold them to little yardage.
Collier back into the ball game. So between Collier, Jamari Taylor, Chris Mosley, all who have had carries tonight from their running back position. Richard finds Collier wide open in space in the flat. And as a quarterback, you've got to love this.
He's picking apart. I mean, he knew right away. Watch how quickly he gets rid of his ball. Oh, he's running by himself. Let me get the ball to him all the way. I mean, right away, 5 yard throw, pick up 15, 20 yards on it. He identified the mic. He's reading the coverages. That's thinking ahead of the crew.
Davius Richard, 233 yards through the air, 5 completions of 20 yards or more tonight. Here's Collier, who's wrapped up and taken to the ground. That's Xavier Shell on the tackle. So from the eye test says, NCCU being methodical, milking the clock, driving the ball down the field. They're not looking ahead. They want to still have to finish off this game, but South Carolina State is the team to take down the reigning HBCU national champions, and NCCU will have their shot next weekend in Orangeburg.
I wonder what old Buddy Pugh's thinking about as he's watching this game, and I know he is. A bit intimidating performance right now. But I think the thing that really will surprise people, you know, was the question mark was, you know, how good this offensive line was. They played really well. Nice pocket for Richard, and they've been able to run. I think we have to add that as, hey, that's one of the strengths of this team. We know Davis Richard's going to do the right thing. We've seen him grow up over his career at Central. But now feeling confident in the pocket, had a dynamic running back like Collier.
Third and 7, pass complete, and just willing his way into the end zone, Jamari Taylor. But again, you got to give it up for that O-line, just like you mentioned, Jay.
I mean, Corey Bullock came and just moved the pile there. The push, when it looked like he was going to be stopped just a little bit short. Watch number 51. You'll see the recognition. He's coming there. Watch his push. Take him in there with you. Cross that goal line. That's wanting it. Give him an assist for the touchdown. Did they give assist in football, or is that just basketball?
It's just basketball. That's okay. We can give him, we can give him an assist here.
Take a look at it. You see the moves, the shifting it. But look at this push. The Eagles are soaring here in Durham.
So?
The new iPhone 14 Pro. It's amazing.
Yep, the camera is incredible. And you'll get our best deal.
Nice, but everyone should get it.
Everyone can get it.
Every new customer.
And every existing customer.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Okay, my work here is done. Everyone gets the best deal on every iPhone.
Best one yet.
Everyone gets AT&T's best deals on every iPhone, including up to $800 off iPhone 14 Pro.
Are you coming for my job?
As someone with hearing loss, I know what a confusing and frustrating experience getting hearing aids can be. That's why I founded Lively. Affordable, high-quality hearing aids with all of the features you need and none of the hassle.
I use Lively hearing aids, and it's been wonderful.
It's so light and so small.
But it's a fraction of the cost of the other devices.
They cost thousands less.
It's insanely user-friendly. You take the hearing test online, the doctor programs in the settings, you don't even need to go into an office.
They're delivered to your door in a few days, and you're up and running in no time.
It connects via Bluetooth to my phone.
You can stream music, and you can answer phone calls.
The audiologist was so incredible.
She's full of all kinds of little helpful hints.
I love it.
They're a game changer for me.
I feel like I could take on anything.
It feels great to be in control of my hearing.
Better hearing has never been this easy. Try Lively risk-free for 100 days. Visit listenlively.com.
This is El Clasico.
Beautiful shot of the moon. Hey, it is a gorgeous night here in Durham. 63 degrees. Couldn't ask for a better fall night for football. Damon Wilson, the new face in the MEAC this season, coming over from Division II Bowie State to take over the Morgan State Bears. Lee Robinson Jr. at Alabama State. Hugh Jackson over at Grambling State. And then Bubba McDowell, Eric Dooley, also finding spaces in the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
A week ago, we thought, you know, it was Bubba McDowell was the guy. Best hire of that list. Team was winning, had 3 conference wins already. But after taking a loss to Southern, now Southern saying, no, we got the right guy in Dooley. Eddie Robinson Jr. obviously was in the news for the spirited post-game press conference after a hard-fought contest. That's one thing I don't like. I don't like how the post-game took over an actual good game we saw. Alabama State was bringing it to play against Jackson State, taking on the number one team in black college football, and it was sad that that was the headline afterwards. What do you see? You saw that whole list there. Who are the coaches stand out to you? New faces, new places.
Well, I do like what Eddie Robinson Jr. is doing at Alabama State, and we continue to see this trend of alums going back to their universities. So Eddie Robinson, who played at Alabama State, now leading the charge of his program. Trey Oliver, as we mentioned, an alumnus of North Carolina Central. Carson Baker with the pass, and it's complete to Damon Hamler.
Trying to figure out what's going on down in Grambling.
Yeah.
Hugh Jackson, it's been tough. But lost a close game the last time out on the field. They finally scored a lot of points versus Alabama A&M, but came up short in overtime. They had high expectations down in Grambling, which they always do. I mean, the most popular HBCU football program in the world, so they don't like being down.
Another long program who won the Celebration Bowl out of the SWAC as here it is, Jabril Johnson, and Johnson, who was the primary back a season ago, with a big gain, pickup of 22.
See Johnson find a crease, and they say he's a very good runner, more than capable, but with the year Alonzo Graham has had, we haven't seen as many touches from Johnson, but way to make the most of the opportunity, the junior from Baltimore, Maryland, McDonough High School.
So he's from McDonough. Alfonso Graham, who he shares the backfield with sometimes, is from Dunbar.
Those are opposites, yeah.
Yeah.
But they're both, what the coaches say, they're both Baltimore tough.
Right.
Why don't they utilize a little bubble screen, wide receiver screen? I mean, look how long they are on the outside. I mean, they've gotten length on the outside, small in the slot. Giving the ball to one of these guys to see if they can break a tackle.
B.T. Sherman, who came over from Norfolk State, now the offensive coordinator for the Bears. The pressure, feeling it, and Mansfield again in to help bring him down.
Good job of getting to the quarterback, number zero. Anytime you can have one of those interior linemen get to the quarterback, they're meeting at the pile. We also saw Jesse Malik was there. We just don't see Baker ever getting comfortable. He doesn't look that comfortable in the pocket. I think that's why he likes to scramble a little bit. When he gets the most out of his pre-snap read and he sees it right away, can be effective, but in terms of creating and sitting comfortable in the pocket, we haven't seen that.
Baker stepping up, and it's intercepted through the hands of Johnson and into the hands of the Eagles. Malcolm Reed, the freshman out of Raleigh, North Carolina, comes up with a pick.
You see here, just not quite comfortable, lets the ball get away, tip drill, interception.
Time for basketball. A season fresh with hope and stars vying for greatness. Heated rivalries with MVP talent. NBA opening week begins Wednesday and continues Friday on ESPN.
Local Ashley store has all the top mattress brands in stock and ready for fast delivery. And right now, you can get 0% interest for 60 months on select Tempur-Pedic, Beautyrest Black, and Purple mattresses. Visit your local Ashley store or shop online today.
We're on pace to set a new staring contest record here at the Nissan Heisman House. Who blinks first? Visit theheismanhouse.com and see if it's you.
So?
The new iPhone 14 Pro. It's amazing.
Yep, the camera is incredible.
Well, Davius Richard brought some of his best games against Morgan State both last season and here tonight. A career-high 6 touchdowns as Richard's night is done, and Walker Harris, the backup quarterback, coming in. The sophomore lefty looking to put it in the air, avoids a few tacklers, but is brought down. Lawrence Richardson stops him. Walker Harris who is a competitor, who has shown that he can step in these moments behind Davius Richard, and certainly now he gets his opportunity on national television on this Thursday night.
Anytime a coach starts out describing about, he's a gunslinger. Yeah. He likes to throw it, takes a couple risks with the ball, but accurate arm, more than capable backup.
Lefty, they hand it off, yeah.
Lefty.
To Josh Pullen, another running back for the Eagles. First time he's carried the rock tonight.
They brought in Walker Harris. I mean, they brought in the twos. I mean, they're giving the offensive line, all the starting offensive linemen. Corey Bullock is out. Simpson's out. Simpkins out. So, good opportunity for these young guys to get some reps. And I think also you can partially call it a sign of respect to Morgan State. Trey Oliver's been there as a first-year coach, knowing what it's like when you don't have your guys.
After three quarters, it's NCCU in complete control. They add another touchdown. They're up big going into the fourth.
Uh-oh, you heard a screech outside at night, but you can't see what it is because there's not enough light. You need the Bionic Floodlight from Bell & Howell, the solar-powered, motion-activated, multi-directional floodlight that showers a super span of light right where you need it. Simply stake it in the yard or mount it anywhere around your home. The onboard solar panel absorbs the sun all day to energize a flood of light at night. No wires or installation frustration. Watch. The instant motion is detected. The Bionic Floodlight triggers 108 high-intensity LED bulbs on three separate panels. That instantly blasts an area of over 1,000 square feet with bright, penetrating light. Then automatically shuts off after the motion stops. Each panel is fully adjustable to direct the right light to the right spot. The Bionic Floodlight is the versatile wireless, safety, security, and outdoor lifestyle light you'll love. And is from Bell & Howell, the brand name your family has trusted for over 100 years. No more arriving to a dark driveway or house at night. Place them in the ground to illuminate walkways and entryways. Add an evening accent light to your garden or mount it to keep unwanted critters away. Adjust the panels to light your deck and your food on the grill at the same time. Add light by the hot tub or pool without dangerous electrical wires. Host the nighttime neighborhood hoops games and enjoy the great outdoors at night, right out your back door or in the backyard. Move it anywhere for any reason and in any weather in any season. Best of all, it's backed by our exclusive Bell & Howell Bionic 10-Year Satisfaction Guarantee. Get the Bionic Floodlight by Bell & Howell, and right now it's yours for just $29.95. But wait, call right now and you can get a second Bionic Floodlight for 50% off. And we'll even ship it to you free. Here's how to order.
Call 1-800-464-1295 or go to bionicfloodlight.com. So call 1-800-464-1295 or order online at bionicfloodlight.com.
HBCU football at its finest on this Thursday night from the Bull City. The men of Omega Sci-Fi. We spotted them on the sideline for NCCU. They played Atomic Dog and immediately Q's know exactly what to do.
What about my man, though, that was solo? That came out the stands in the end zone, was hopping by himself.
It only takes one. Oh, just a party of one. It's a one-man show, if necessary. And then the coaches came over to corral the guys and said, all right.
Yeah. I think you give credit to, they started to create a nice football atmosphere here. A pretty good Thursday night crowd that came out. In school, they were excited. You know, we filmed Black College Live today in the pregame show, and you can tell the students and everybody's excited. They're trying to do something special here in 2022.
They feel really good about what they've been able to put together so far. Remember, they closed out the season with three wins. They started the year with another four. So seven straight dating back to last season before last weekend's loss. We'll get the call on the penalty.
Personal foul, leaping the punch shield, number 81 of the receiving team. The penalty is 15 yards from the previous spot. Will be an automatic first down.
Wow, so
it's not one you hear called.
Yeah, North Carolina. North Carolina Central is going to get the ball.
Yeah.
So they'll keep possession of the ball. Let's see, they said number 81 left his feet. They're trying to get rid of that there, that leaping. I mean, it's kind of tough because you're not even supposed to form a wedge, and that almost looked like a wedge that they had. But in terms of player safety, tough break for Morgan State.
So NCCU's offense back on the field. First and 10 and on the carry. A few sidesteps and just trying to find a little room. Chris Mosley. Well, when we talked with Trey Oliver, part of the reason for their success and why they, what they've been able to rally around is being great. Grit, relentless, effort, attitude, and also being tenacious. That's part of being great. And Davius Richard, who was on our Black College Live show earlier today, you know, talked about just the belief. The belief that, yes, we can be great.
So I didn't know about that one until you and Davius talked about it earlier. So be great is not just a slogan, but it's an acronym, as we call it at Howard University Education Tells.
You know, it's a MEAC game. It's totally warranted here. Not going to say anything else about that. We'll have the call of America's Classic this weekend between Harvard and Howard at Audi Field, 4 o'clock Saturday. Well, 3rd and 11 coming up. Looking down the field, and the gunslinger Walker Harris completes the pass and keeps it moving. Joaquin Davis with the reception.
And it all started in the backfield. I mean, watch the footwork here. Pass rush coming, just sidestep it. Right-handed quarterback, that might have been trouble, but Walker Harris is a lefty. Sees his wide receiver settling on the sideline for the completion and the first down.
Walker Harris came in to this game, 4 of 6 on the season. Nearly picked off by Caleb Coleman. And if he would have had it, it would have been to the house.
Yeah, you have to make this catch. Great job. Does everything but make the catch. Maybe the left-handed quarterback threw him off. Those balls come in there a little bit different with that spin and a little wobble. But he would definitely been off to the races for the easy pick six. Missed opportunity for big play.
It's Luke Bracey in motion. The handoff to Pullen. Pullen across the 10 and down about the 9-yard line, stopped by Lawrence Richardson. Well, anytime that it's been in the red zone, like, I'm going to use the slogan, Eagle Pride Amplified. It's been Eagle Pride Amplified when they go down into the red zone. 8 drives, 7 touchdowns tonight for NCCU. And their 6th trip tonight. Inside the 20. We'll see if they're able to walk away with another score. Pulling towards that left side. Sidestep, good feet kept it moving.
This is close here. Probably go for the field goal here. Out of respect, but you know, if you're Trey Oliver, you want to see, what did your twos do? It was the twos on offense for North Carolina Central going against the ones. I mean, the Morgan State ones are still out there. They picked up a couple first downs. They showed just some life in an uphill type case. So I think Coach Oliver has to be pleased with some of the work he saw out there from his backups.
Carlos Beltran Rodriguez on for the chip shot at 23-yard.
Carlos Beltran's a baseball player.
Yeah, Rodriguez at there, yeah. Tacking on some more here from Dorr.
There is something greater than finishing first.
True champions stand on principles.
We fight for the right causes. We believe in the
power of teamwork, whether in rebounding, receiving, or in research.
In service and in sportsmanship.
Only a few have what it really takes.
We develop the talent. We unleash the potential.
It all boils down to this. Now
is the time. This is the place.
We are MEAC.
You know what beats next day shipping? Getting it the same day. So shop Ace online and get free in-store or curbside pickup right in your neighborhood. Or get what you need delivered the very same day you order.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Well, this resume is getting seen, just not by who you want. You need a better plan.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. An Indeed resume gets you seen by the right people. All without having to do one dance move.
So I had to quit college to help my mom, but I never wanted to quit my dream of a career in IT.
There are over 260,000 IT support specialist job openings in America. On Coursera, you can earn Google's IT support professional certificate designed to prepare you for an IT support career in about 5 months for $39 a month. No degree or experience needed.
My job now is amazing. I can spend more time with my family.
Find courses, certificates, and degrees on Coursera. Join for free at Coursera.org. Coursera, learn without limits.
It all started when we showed up in Austin waving a Wazoo flag, trying to get game day to come to Pullman. Then it kind of became an obsession. I'm Tom Pounds, and this is the story of the Cougar that wouldn't quit. We flew Old Crimson at every game day. And after 15 years, game day finally came to Washington State. And I lost my mind. Now we keep doing it because game day isn't just a day, it's a lifestyle.
Now to the sound machine here at O'Kelly Riddick Stadium. Good time to remind you that the Sunday NFL Countdown crew has you covered for week 6 starting at 10 a.m. Eastern, and the Monday Night Countdown crew gets you ready for Broncos Chargers at 6 Eastern. Both are available on ESPN and the app. Jay Walker, Tiffany Green back with you on the return. We saw an electrifying return from Keith Jenkins earlier in this game. He sets his team across the 33-yard line. Coming up this weekend, Harvard taking on Howard. The Bison are looking to trend in the right direction before they start off conference play. But when you look at the numbers across the board, pretty evenly match between the two.
They have a chance. I mean, Howard's been in most games. They haven't been blown out by too many. They get late starts, but I don't need to see yards per game and all that stuff. I want to see GPAs, Rhodes Scholars, the Truth in Service Classic at Audi Field is what I'm interested in seeing. But two of the, you know, you're gonna call me a homer, but two of the premier academic institutions. Howard has often been called the Harvard HBCU. So, you know, be interesting to bring the academic schools together. But Harvard's coming there with a pretty good football team. 3-1. Pretty impressive start for Crimson.
I have to let you have your moment and have your time. It's going to hurt me to call this game with you this weekend because you're going
to
just
It just hurts you to give Howard credit for anything. Yeah,
that's not true.
Well, why didn't you agree with me that Howard is the academic leader?
Howard is an outstanding academic institution.
The academic leader
New quarterback in for Morgan State. I give it credit. It is an outstanding academic institution, no doubt. As Deuce Taylor in now for Maryland's preeminent public urban research institution, Morgan State. Hands off to Alfonso Graham. See what I did there? You like that?
Like their president, Dr. Wilson, likes to call it the national treasure that is Morgan State University.
Well, we talk so much about the hire of Damon Wilson, but Dina Freeman Patton became the VP and director for intercollegiate athletics, the first woman in the institution's 155-year history to oversee the athletic department. So newcomers at Morgan State looking to have this program trending in the right direction under the leadership of Damon Wilson. Continuing just to scramble, stay on his feet. Deuce Taylor finally found a man, but in and out of the hands of Anthony James.
And just want to say well wishes, or what do you think about the hire of a new athletic director down at your alma mater, Florida A&M? Another Tiffany down in Tallahassee, the Tiffany Dawn Sykes.
Tiffany Dawn Sykes, who has experience as we take a look at Deuce Taylor just trying to keep that play alive. It's certainly one when we talked with both Damon Wilson and Trey Oliver, they really liked the hire, felt like she had a number of years of experience around HBCU programs.
Is she also the first female ever to lead FAMU athletics? Maybe.
We'll find out on the other side of the break as we step aside. 9:06 remaining here from NCCU.
You know this bloke, right? And this fella? They've got a few quid, so they thought they'd buy a football club in a town they'd never been to, over 5,000 miles from home. As you do.
Yes!
But those lads have got the town absolutely buzzing. School kids rapping, this nutter got a tattoo. Trips to Wembley, even Maureen's getting involved. Let's have it, Maureen! FX's Welcome to Wrexham. All episodes now streaming on Hulu.
I'm the captain of the Pee Wee football team. We are
mighty!
Annoying. Go, go. Thanks, Mom. If you have cut-rate car insurance, then not even a Hail Mary will save you from paying for this. So get Allstate.
Tell me what I've done to you.
I just don't like, you know.
ESPN College Football is presented by McDonald's Black and Positively Golden Movement, elevating the next generation of Black excellence.
Well, back in April, North Carolina Central opened their student center, the ribbon cutting ceremony for the $55 million facility, a part of the Millennial Campus celebration, in addition to three residence buildings. And this state-of-the-art facility, we got a chance to record our Black College live show from there. Event hall, great sound stage, multi-purpose rooms, a number of eating options for the students, gaming area as well. It's top-notch.
You know, I try not to be what we call a play hater, but where was this stuff when I was in school? When you were in school, when you see the stuff there, you're glad that they've evolved and they're getting facilities that are second to none.
Well, if you're just tuning in, folks, we'll bring you up to speed on North Carolina Central, located in Durham, North Carolina, about 7,900 plus students strong. We've heard a little bit from the marching sound machine. You may have checked them out over on ESPN3 during halftime. And Jay, you got a chance to give your five, your gimme five of some of the top alumnus, the most famous and notable. And among them, Sam Jones topped the list.
Yeah, Sam Jones, Pro Basketball Hall of Famer. I'm sorry, Frank Turner, you did not make my list. My little homer call. Robert Massey could have made my list as well. But Richard Sly, tallest person ever to play in the National Football League at 7 feet tall. But it's Jay's gimme five. You want to talk about it? Hit me up on Black College Live.
Josh Pullen. That's not Josh Pullen. Again, they're making sure that everyone gets opportunities. That's Arthur Rogers. Your gimme five list, Jay.
You can't beat that list.
I think it's a very powerful list.
You can't beat that list. Wild Bill Hayes, the legendary Aggie coach and coach at Winston-Salem State, but I think a lot of people don't realize this is where he graduated from. So, Bill with it. Maynard Jackson, number two. You know how many times I've gone to Atlanta and people have asked, was I his son?
Oh, really?
The older I got, I was like, oh, okay, I see it a little bit.
I mean, possibly. I could see it. You talked about Wild Bill Hayes. Robert Massey is now the head coach of the Rams at Winston-Salem State. There's an injured NCCU player on the field. Chris Escalara, the backup left guard, is down. And so while he's tended to, we will step aside quickly.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, people like Geico because it's just easy. Bundling, for example. You've got car insurance here and home insurance here. Why not? Zoop, put them together. Save even more. Some things are better together, aren't they? Like tea and crumpets. You wouldn't bundle just anything. Like, say, a porcupine in a balloon factory. Now, that'd be a mess. I mean, for starters, porcupines are famously no good in a team setting.
Geico. Save even more when you bundle home and car insurance.
Next to Market Watch, numbers. Boring. In more delicious news, Carl's Jr. and Hardee's are offering Charbroil Double Deals starting at $2.99 each.
Bite into these double deals starting at $2.99 each at Carl's Jr. and Hardee's.
For Imprint, this is Lisa.
Hi, I'd like 50 Welcome Wows and 300 Customer I Love It.
Promotional products from For Imprint are certain to deliver ooh yes.
Wow.
I love it.
Find some wow now at forimprint.com. For Imprint, for certain.
An ABC doubleheader.
A battle of the Big 12 unbeaten.
Undefeated Clemson, the crucial Atlantic Coast Conference collision.
You have no idea what's going to happen on any given Saturday.
Oklahoma State, TCU. Clemson, Florida State. Saturday on ABC.
Prelims starting at 4 Eastern, followed by the main card at 7 Eastern, featuring Alexa and Viviani in the women's flyweight main event. To get it, go to ESPNplus.com or download the ESPN app.
Can we mention the respect? In this game right now, it's twos versus twos. And I think that comes from Trey Oliver knowing, hey, the same things make you laugh, make you cry, not trying to rub it in. Basically took it easy on them in the second half once the game was in hand. And stay healthy. You know, let the backups play on national TV. We'll call out some names you normally don't hear called and see if you can find a spark or somebody that can earn some more playing time.
I agree, Jay, and that's, you know, something that we haven't necessarily seen in some of our games that we've called this season as Rodgers getting the carry again It was North Carolina Central who really came out and started fast. That's what Trey Oliver talked about he wanted to do. He wanted to come out, get off to a quick start. And since then, it was pretty smooth in most aspects of the game.
Yeah. Well, next week, though, you know, that's what I always say. Mm-hmm. Hey, they look good, but if one team doesn't care, that team down in Orangeburg, they're saying, we'll see how good you are when you come down to the Bird next weekend. Because I think a lot of people are fooled by South Carolina State's record. South Carolina State has played arguably the toughest schedule in HBCU football. I mean, 1-4, I know they played with Central Florida. I know they played South Carolina. They took on North Carolina A&T, which is a blue blood in HBCU. They took on Florida A&M. What was that? They beat Bethune-Cookman. So, you know, I'm thinking Buddy Pough saying, we're going to play as tough a schedule we can so that MEAC play becomes, you know, not overwhelming for us. So we'll see if it pays off.
And he always brings a very formidable defense as Arthur Rogers picks up the first down. And then when you look at the remaining teams within the MEAC, we talked about Norfolk State.
Don't know what's going on there.
Yeah, it's been a rough start for Dawson Odoms. They picked up their first win in conference play last week over Morgan State. Delaware State hosting, or rather they're traveling to Norfolk, but the Hornets coming off that win over Robert Morris. We saw them have some really good moments last season with Rod Milstead.
Up and down, some disappointing losses and some losses where you shake your head and some games they should have won. So I think those teams just need to have more consistency. You know, I think consistency is the key. We've seen Central become more consistent. Will Morgan become more consistent? I mean, you can win some games up there, knock out with Sacred Heart, I think, and some other schools, and they've been competitive, but...
This Morgan State program, home to 4 Pro Football Hall of Famers. And 4, Roosevelt Brown, Leroy Kelly, Willie Lanier. Mosley, and Mosley finds his way. Oh, I like that little celebration at the end. Touchdown, Eagles. Because you always have to find ways to be creative to celebrate and not get a penalty for it.
And with the momentum there and the hard running, I like that. I don't know what that celebration was.
I don't know what it was either.
But it was well synchronized. The timing of it was nice.
With that extra point, tying the most points that NCCU has scored this season. There's 3:16 remaining. Eagles celebrating. Eagle pride amplified here in Durham.
Mass General Brigham. When you need some of the brightest minds in medicine, this is a leading healthcare system with 5 nationally ranked hospitals, including 2 world-renowned academic medical centers. In Boston, where biotech innovates daily, and our doctors teach at Harvard Medical School, and the physicians doing the world-changing research are the ones providing care. There's only one Mass General Brigham.
When you start with better ingredients, better pizza, you also get better papadillas, better cheese sticks, better yummy this, and better tasty that.
You can get with this, or you can get with that.
Get any 2 or more for just $6.99 each. That's Papa John's.
So?
The new iPhone 14 Pro. It's amazing.
Yep, the camera is incredible. And you'll get our best deal.
Nice. But everyone should get it.
Everyone can get it.
Every new customer.
And every existing customer.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Every iPhone.
Okay, my work here is done. Everyone gets the best deal on every iPhone.
Best one yet.
Everyone gets AT&T's best deals on every iPhone, including up to $800 off iPhone 14 Pro.
Are you coming for my job?
In 3 seconds, what? This couple will share a perfect moment.
Is that...
Oh, wow. But we gotta sell our houses.
Well, almost perfect. Don't worry. Sell with confidence to Open Door.
Yes.
Done. Request a cash offer at opendoor.com.
Let's take a look at tonight's Bring in the Flavor by, brought to you by McDonald's. Hey, look, we've been giving props all night long to the NCCU student section. Thursday nights sometimes can be a little dicey on a college campus. You know, students may or may not, and they came out tonight, and they were ready. They brought their spirit. They've had it all day long. They were clothed in it since the start of the day. They were ready, and look, there's just an excitement in the air here at NCCU.
When your football team is good and winning games, you tend to build a following. You know, I talked to folks where, you know, we saw A.J. Calloway here. What does A.J. talk about? He loved Howard, but he said, man, when that football team was winning. So I think, you know, winning's contagious for school spirit. It helps with enrollment. And you do get the feeling they're doing something special here. So hats off to athletic director Skip Perkins for the job he's doing in accommodating that and capturing that spirit, that energy that's new here on campus.
Bruce Taylor sees that in the hands of Hamler. Jay, it's going to be an interesting road to Atlanta for the Cricket Celebration Bowl. Right now, the front runners, as you mentioned, North Carolina Central out of the MEAC and Jackson State out of the SWAC. But what have we learned about the MEAC? Their physicality stands out every single time when the clash happens, or oftentimes, rather, when the clash happens between the conferences.
Still in the trenches. You know, and I kind of alluded to earlier, I think we have to go to break, but for the MEAC, you have to take pride in the fact that North Carolina Central, your number one team.
Ooh, you see that sidestep, don't you?
Yes.
We got to give Juice Taylor some love for that.
Well, think about it. If Central's going to be your premier team in the conference, they beat A&T, who's projected to win the Big South. They beat New Hampshire from the CAA conference, which is a top 25 team, which is a multi-bid. So Central's making the case for, we play some good football. And if they get the victory next week at South Carolina State, then I think the rest of the country is going to take notice of it. You know, and it's also, folks who want to hear this, you saw the power rankings earlier, but Florida A&M finds himself in that chase position again. You know, they need somebody to beat Jackson State, not once, but twice. So Willie Simmons and the Rattlers probably plan to get another invitation back to the FCS playoffs as an at-large.
And then who do you think has the best chance of perhaps delivering a loss to Jackson State? Who's?
They take care of their business against some good teams. I mean, the only team left they got to face on the east side is Alabama A&M. Now, A&M, believe it or not, as bad as they look, they've got a scenario in which they can win the SWAC East. Now, they'd have to beat Jackson State. They'd have to win the Classic as well. They lost to FAMU, so they'd have to do some tie-break scenarios, three-way tie where they could do it. But it's a tough task. All torn. At the end of the year, you have to wonder, is it going to be wrapped up by the time Jackson State gets to Auburn? when they play the last game of the year, when the Jacks, they have anything on the line.
With Damon Wilson and Morgan State will drop to 2-4 with a minute 34 remaining in this one.
That was North Carolina Central alum Moses Ware. Played ball here now, coaching at Morgan State. Coached here for a while.
And how about Joseph Awumi? Nearly got into the end zone. Just short, but first and goal for the Bears, and they got a chance to get it in.
It's the fourth quarter, minute 26, and they finally threw the ball to those big, long wide receivers I talked about. You know, when you got guys like this, get them the ball, see if they can make a miss. 6'3", 200-pound wide receivers, you know, don't come a dime a dozen. I would have given them a hitch route, some quick game stuff, to let them try and run through some tackles.
Jabril Johnson on the carry, bounces off, still moving ahead, and they'll say he's just short of the end zone.
And I like the officials right now. I promise you I saw no less than two holding by the offensive line in white. I mean, they were some bear hugs, but hey, at this point in the game, it's not impacting the game. Let it go.
And surging ahead and pushing through, and Deuce Taylor and the Bears are into the end zone. So the talented backup quarterback is able to get it in with under a minute to go. And you like to see that, Coach Wilson bringing in the young quarterback and having a quick conversation.
Coach him up.
Yep, always.
He's coaching. They like Deuce Taylor. Could be their future guy and say he could do some special things. Has a strong arm, quick feet.
Well, our next night of top-ranked boxing is in Melbourne, Australia. The main event is coming your way, featuring the undisputed American Devin Haney against the Aussie George Kambosos for a repeat match from Down Under. Coverage of the main card begins at 10:30 Eastern on ESPN, ESPN Deportes, and ESPN Plus. You see from Deuce Taylor. But the bands still keep the party going up in the stands.
And hats off to Oregon State sending their band down here.
Yeah.
You know, conference game, they wanted to help out making the drive. So always good when you see the visiting team's band make the trip down to support the football team, whatever athletic team it may be.
Saw wonky onside kick last weekend out of the Big 12, and Oklahoma State was able to kind of get this odd dodging of the rule with the fair catch, and we'll see here if it may be utilized. Would matter not, however. Twan Flip. And Flip on the return. And Twan Flip has some room. The sidestep. And Flip, who we got a chance to talk with Coach Oliver about, said, you know what I like, Twan Flip? This young man, redshirt freshman out of Charlotte, motivational speaker, has got a huge heart in here on national television. He gets to return a kick for good yards.
And he tried to cut on a dime. Yeah. You got to gather your feet underneath you. Those are fresh young legs just racing 100 miles an hour when the body was prepared to just go about 70 miles an hour. But look at that. He came in with some excitement. And can we give credit? Can we show a shot of the back of the helmets from North Carolina Central? man, I love it where on the back you see the last name, you know, Gilbert. You know, Tuan Flip, I saw Flip Jr. for Davis Richard, kept seeing Richard. Like, oh, I like that. See, man, these new kids have all this swag. HBCU culture's changed so much. They've got uniform combinations now. They get the name not only on the back of their jersey, but you get on the back of your helmet now, too. Man.
And Quest Powell, the third-string quarterback, coming in victory formation to close out this game. Jay, what a dominating performance we saw from North Carolina Central tonight. 530 yards of total offense as they will rack up their first win in conference play.
Yep, they got win number one, but win number two is going to be the one. Next week against the Bulldogs, South Carolina State. Enjoy it for a couple days, but we'll see what's up next week when we go down to the Burg.
A career night for Davius Richard. Six touchdowns as North Carolina Central with a commanding 59-20 victory over Morgan State. For Jay Walker, I'm Tiffany Green saying so long from Durham. Now, let's send it to baseball tonight right after these messages. Until the next.